going, whether it's sand or surfboard. Diversified Leasing has the right trust for you.
KHNL presents University of Hawaii Rainbow Football.
Bob Wagner's Rainbows are riding high. This week, they find themselves ranked second in the nation in scoring and tied for 20th in the UPI coaches poll. In five games, the Rainbows have scored 30 touchdowns, nine of them by freshman running back Jamal Farmer. But much of the credit belongs to the special teams and a pressure defense that has produced the Western Athletic Conference's most favorable turnover margin. Tonight, that defense will be tested by Al Luganville's San Diego State Aztecs, who are ranked third in the nation in total offense. Last week, quarterback Dan McGuire threw for 510 yards and two touchdowns. His favorite target, the WAC's leading receiver, Monty Gilbert, who's caught at least one pass in 29 straight games. From Aloha Stadium, it's Hawaii against San Diego State.
Rainbow Football is sponsored by Miller Lite. When it's Miller Lite, less filling tastes great. And by Chevron at High Octane Chevron Supreme with Tech Relief. Chevron, we're with you all the way.
Hello again, everybody, and welcome to our coverage of Western Athletic Conference football. Tonight, Hawaii against San Diego State. And San Diego State, the designated rival of the Rainbows, I guess you could say so geographically. These are the only two teams in the conference that play their schedule at sea level. With me again tonight is Rick Blangiardi, but it goes deeper than that. Ever since the first game in 1939, 6-6-2 is the record.
Yeah, real natural rivals, Jim, and I think recruiting has something to do with it. And just the fact that San Diego State over the years has had good football teams, and they've always played Hawaii very tough.
San Diego State brings in another vaunted quarterback tonight in Dan McGuire, 6'8", 570 yards in total offense last week.
McGuire is a real key to tonight's game, because I think what San Diego State has, and it's classic in sports, they have potential. How they decide to attack the Hawaii defense, which has really shown a lot the last couple of weeks, remains key. If they go to the quick game, McGuire could be very effective. That's what Hawaii will have to shut down. In a deep game, he's pretty immobile as a quarterback.
As far as the Rainbows are concerned, they have put 60 points or more on the board the last 2 weeks. And last week, Garrett Gabriel coming off his best game ever, only 194 yards, but very effective performance.
Yeah, Garrett's playing real well, and the team is picking up behind that in all phases of the game. The quarterback position in the spread offense is absolutely key. When Garrett is going well, I think the whole thing works extremely well.
Also with us tonight is Bobby Curran. Bobby, even though San Diego State puts a lot of points on the board, 41 against Fullerton early, and they came away with their first win last week against Utah, their defense has given up a lot of yardage.
Jim, they've had some troubles defensively. The basic problem is not their athletes. They have excellent athletes back there. Their problem has been busted coverages. No cohesion among the various players. They've given up a lot of big plays. Busted coverages have been the problem. They're 103 out of 105 in total defense, and a lot of those plays have led to big scores.
One thing that the Rainbows have to do again tonight, Bobby, that's pounce on San Diego State right away?
Going to have to get them quick. You can maybe take the heart out of San Diego State. Some people feel that that's the key to them. Get on them early. Don't let them build up ahead of steam.
One thing about San Diego State fans and coaches and players, they think they are improving week after week. They're going to give Hawaii a stern test tonight. When we return, we'll have the opening kickoff, Hawaii against San Diego State.
I'm tired of us centers getting no recognition. I played 13 seasons in front of millions of fans, made All-Pro twice, and started in three Super Bowls. Yet no one knows who I am. Hey, even if I'm not well-known, at least my beer is. Miller Lite. An All-Pro center doesn't want some watered-down version of a regular beer. I want the less filling beer that tastes great.
Let me get that.
Aren't you Randy Cross?
It's well known. When it's Miller Lite, less filling tastes great.
The Hawaiian Homes Commission Act was supposed to rehabilitate Native Hawaiians by returning them to the land. But through decades of abuse and mismanagement, Hawaiians have waited. Many have died without ever seeing their Aina. How did this happen? How can it be remedied? Back to the Aina takes an in-depth look at the Hawaiian Homelands Program on Wednesday night at 8:05. Back to the Aina, a special presentation of Hawaii's very own KHNL Channel 13.
Welcome back, everybody. San Diego State taking the field here. both just coming out of their tunnel across the way. The captains meeting in the center of the field. The San Diego State-Hawaii series goes all the way back to 1939. And when they come into the Aloha Stadium tonight, the overall series, 6 wins, 6 losses, and 2 ties. So these two teams really have played each other over the years even. And in the WAC, Hawaii has a very slight edge, 4-3-2, in Honolulu, San Diego State. You can see that they have 4 wins. So now the Rainbows start to come out. The Rainbows 4-1 on the season. And the Rainbows have won the toss, and they have elected to defer. So we're moments away from the opening kickoff here at Aloha Stadium tonight in Honolulu. Very threatening skies before the start of tonight's game, especially, hour and a half before, we had a very slight sprinkle. The clouds were ominous. They were foreboding. And yet they have moved on. There has been rain during this week, but the AstroTurf in very good shape going into tonight's game. The wind will not be a factor. There you see Coach Bob Wagner, always with the flower lay, 18-11, and Coach Al Luganville is in his first year, 1-2-1. This is a very important game for Al Luganville. Rainbows are second in the nation as far as scoring. They average 47 points a game. And so tonight could be a wide open affair. It will take some time, especially if McGuire and Gabriel go to the air. It will take some time to play it.
You know, Jim, there's a lot of different things I think that motivate a football team coming in. And the Bulls have been kind of going along, especially in the last 2 weeks, with great offensive performances and real solid defensive performances, as well as the kicking game. And things were looking nice. But I really think that the ranking this past week, putting Hawaii at 20th in the nation and giving them some recognition that they haven't had in a long time, having been passed up in a bowl game last year, I really think for this team tonight is really going to be a motivating factor with the momentum of being 4-1. I think that's just going to be the added shot in the arm. I look for Hawaii to play very aggressive.
Not only that, the Rainbows have made one poll, the UPI coaches poll. They are tied for 20th with Florida State. A win tonight could possibly boost them into not only the UPI poll, but also the Associated Press top 25.
The flip side of that equation, though, is San Diego State has a tremendous incentive coming in. They can come in here and knock off a team that's in the top 20. They'll be sky high as well.
Absolutely. And they played very well against UCLA. Should not forget that. They've had some bad performances since then, but they tied Fullerton, but they did play very well against a class opponent in UCLA, so we know they have the capability.
Jason Elam will kick off for the Rainbows. Robert Claiborne, number 2, and Darren Wagner, number 22, deep for San Diego State. These two teams are rivals, and we are underway. It will go to Claiborne on the 5, to the 20, to the 23-yard line, and Claiborne upended there. Tackle made by Patrick Gordon and Eric Center. 12-yard kickoff return, first down for San Diego State. Dan McGuire, you see his completions and attempts, 1,464 yards, 6 touchdowns. He has been intercepted 6 times. Rainbow starts with a 3-man defensive line, and then the 4 linebackers, Tali Barnett, Maeva, and Odom. First down, double wide receiver to the left for San Diego State. First down from the 23. In motion is Gilbreth, number 81. And right away, McGuire, hit as he throws, gets the pass away to Gilbreth. Gilbreth over the 25, and his ankle tackled out of the 28-yard line by number 37, Mike Tressler. The backs and receivers for the Aztecs. McGuire, 6'8". Darren Wagner, only a freshman. Monty Gilbreth, leading receiver in the WAC. Then Jimmy Ray. Ray Rowe, the tight end, and Robert Claiborne. And Claiborne really compliments Gilbreth. The offensive line, Subis, Sang, Baldwin, Fortin, and Nichols.
They have really improved in recent weeks. That middle 5 for San Diego State, I really believe, is the absolute key to this ball game tonight.
Second down and 6. Ball has been advanced to the 27. Rainbow showing a 6-man front now. In motion is Ray, number 17. McGuire again to throw. Looks for Ray, throws. It is complete at the 30. Ray with the first down. Out over the 35 to the 37. Kim McLeod making the stop for the Rainbows. First down for San Diego State. So they have come out. They are throwing the ball, and so far he is 2 for 2. Dana Directo, Augie Apelu, and Delmar Johnson on that defensive line, and the linebackers Barnett, Tally Odom, and David Maeva. secondary, Colson, McLeod, Tressler, and Briggs.
And that was the starting team 5 weeks ago. Jim, they've gone to the quick game, and that is really also something that Hawaii has to take away early.
First down for San Diego State at the 37-yard line. Single setback is number four, Ron Slack. Slack gets the handoff, adds the hole, out to the 40. Gain on the play of 3, second down and 7. Joaquin Barnett, number 53, there on the tackle, along with David Maeva, number 31. So Ron Slack out of Pasadena, California. That was his 63rd rush of the season. He has scored 4 touchdowns. Second down and 7 for San Diego State. And they already have 1 first down. Claiborne and Ray are flanked to the near side. Gelbreth now goes in motion. Ball is pitched to Slack. He's in trouble. Gets away from 2 men. But Joaquin Barnett makes the stop for the Rainbows back at the original line of scrimmage, back at the 37-yard line. Good penetration that time.
Excellent penetration. Good team speed by Hawaii. You would suspect that San Diego State is going to open up tonight with a quick passing game, an off play like the draw that they ran. Now they run sort of a traditional power off tackle, and you see the pursuit of the Hawaii defense. They're all over them.
That was their big concern for San Diego State. They say that the skill people in Hawaii are as good as UCLA's. They don't feel that the Hawaii's people are quite as physical. They'll try to exploit that.
Herman Talley getting into the backfield on that last play. Third down and 10. Maeva showing blitz. He does blitz. He's picked up. The throw, complete, incomplete. Gelbreth had his hand on it, but Trussler came up and stripped him of the ball.
That'll be a key matchup tonight. Monty Gelbreth is a great player. He'll be playing for a lot of Sundays and years to come. They'll go to work on Mike Tressler.
Joe Santos in to punt. 16 punts on the year. 40.6 in average, as you see the defensive gem by Tressler. Deep for the Rainbows. Number 4, Briggs, number 26. And 26 is Jeff Seidner. Leads the nation with a 27-yard average in punt return. Kick will go to Briggs. Takes it at the 26. Briggs falls down at the 28. They say his knee touched at the 26-yard line. And the Rainbows will put the ball in play there.
Looks like the film showed that they could block a punt against San Diego State. That time Hawaii came with an all-out block. Burton almost got there. Nonetheless, they get off a 38-yard punt. Briggs returned to 3 yards. And there we take a look at Garrett Gabriel coming onto the field.
So Garrett Gabriel, 47 out of 83, 628 yards, 6 touchdowns. He's been intercepted twice. And the Rainbows begin things. Larry Consmith, number 86 to the near side. Chris Roscoe, 89 to the far side. Mahuka and Ahuna are in the slots. Lamar Young gets the start at single setback. The ball is kept. Long pass over the middle to Mahuka, overthrown at the San Diego State 35. Mahuka had a step on number 30, Johnny Walker. The backs and receivers for the Rainbows. Gabriel at quarterback, Young getting the start, Mahuka and Ahuna, and then Roscoe and Conn Smith. The offensive line, Ali Votto getting the start tonight despite an injury. Larry Jones, Alan Smith, Leo Goas, and Sean Robinson, both Goas and Robinson, playing with casts. Second down and 10. The ball at the 26-yard line. 12:50 left to play, just underway. Hawaii against San Diego State. Ball is pitched back. And carrying the ball is Ahuna out to the 28-yard line. Short gain on the play. The defensive line for San Diego State, Duncan Sangapolotelli, Williams, and Matusiewicz. The linebackers, Mao, Niu, and Wesselman. Wesselman, the WAC player of the week last week against Utah. Drayton Moses, Maxie, and Walker in that defensive secondary. Third down, long yardage, 3rd and 7 for the Rainbows.
I thought Bobby's comments earlier were very precise as to this defensive team for San Diego State. They've been pretty much maligned thus far in this 1-2-1 record, having given up so much defense, but the truth is it's always big plays. They just seem to break down, and if they can keep from doing that, as we just saw, they're going to be formidable. They can move through the football, and they got a nice surge off the ball when the ball snapped.
One area that they've had particular trouble with, Rick, is with the triple option. The Rainbow coaches went to school on that. D. Dallas, of course, he can make some people miss, but they had a lot of missed assignments in the triple option. Expect Hawaii to have a big night on the ground.
Yeah, I think the key there is whether or not Garrett can run that option with the kind of quickness. You know, Garrett thus far hasn't really factored in as much as in the run or the spread offense as a runner. And that'll be a key early on if Garrett can put the pressure on as a runner.
Concern now for Sean Alibata. We mentioned that he was injured last week. And they will help him off. Kalani Kaleleiki will come on and play center for the Rainbows. Palilli, he played three quarters in last week's game.
You know, you really have to admire Sean Olivotto. As you said, Jim, just as we were going through the introduction of the players playing despite the injury, he really rose to the occasion tonight, made every effort to get out there. We'll just have to hope he's okay and comes back.
Third down and seven for the Rainbows. Mahuka and Ahuna in the slots, with Roscoe and Conn Smith as the wide receiver, and Lamar Young getting the start tonight, the fifth-year senior. Gabriel, third down. In motion is Mahuka, four-man front for San Diego State. Gabriel Roller throws long, coming back for the ball and making the catch as Roscoe fumbles the ball. It's picked out of midair by a San Diego State player going down the far sideline, John Wesselman, and it will be first down for San Diego State. And still down on the turf, the Rainbow receiver.
Roscoe seems to be hurt, Jim. They got him in the midsection. That was really the strangest thing. Ball got in there. He had the reception. Concerned now for Chris as he's holding his left arm. 35-yard return. You look at it here. Now, I'm real curious to see if it appears he has the ball. It's in there. The defensive back comes up, tackles the football, punches it up in the air, and very alertly is picked off by Wesselman, and off he goes. Big play.
Oh, big play for San Diego State. John Wesselman, that is his second. I don't know whether you could call that an interception. Maybe it was...
That's an interception.
Yeah, you have to be, because you cannot advance a fumble, right?
That's right. That's
right.
An interception.
So an interception, and the concern for Roscoe as he is taken to the Rainbow bench. Excellent field position, to say the least, for San Diego State. Claiborne to the near side. To the far side is Ray. Single setback is Darren Wagner. First down from the 26-yard line of the Rainbows. Wagner in motion. No setback. McGuire, the big guy, throws, and he is hit as he throws. It falls to the turf untouched. It was intended for Ray Rowe, the tight end.
Well, good sign there on that play. Was something probably nobody really got to watch, and that was down deep where they were looking. The Hawaii defenders were able to lock into the receivers and cover everybody in their patterns man for man. I think that's a good sign, because it's the first deep pattern that San Diego State tried to go to.
Second down and 10 from the Rainbow 26. McGuire looks over a six-man front. McGuire gives it up the middle. Carrying the ball is Wagner, all the way down inside the 20 to the 15, and that is enough for a first down. So the Rainbows were coming on the blitz. They took a chance, and Wagner exploded into the secondary.
And this is a guy Hawaii has really got to watch. Darren Wagner is the real McCoy. You watch him cut back there. He's also a guy, not only is he fast, when he comes at you, he can put a hurting on you when you come up to make the stop.
He's probably one of the best recruits they've landed in a long time. They're very high on him as a redshirt freshman.
Slack now has gone in at single setback. McGuire, first down, gives it to Slack, angling off the right side and dragging people with him. Dragged number 97, Dana Directo, with him on that play. And that gets all the way down inside the 10 to the 8-yard line, the line of scrimmage being the 13.
Pretty good play selection by San Diego State now. They're mixing it up well, trying to keep that Hawaii defense off balance.
11:24 in the first quarter, left to play. No score, but San Diego State threatens. Triple wide receiver to the far side. Gilbert, Nettles, and also Claiborne. McGuire with Slack behind him. McGuire pitches to Slack, comes to the weak side. Slack breaks the tackle at the 5, at the 1-yard line. Again, carrying people with him. Walter Briggs finally wrote him down in the Rainbow secondary. That is enough for a first down. It will be first and goal to go for San Diego State.
Ron Slack, you know, we saw it before in years past there, playing well against Hawaii that time, showing a lot of determination. Jim, I'll tell you, San Diego State has come out here fired up for this game. Nothing flat about this ball club.
Here comes San Diego State. First and goal to go. Wagner now is in the backfield behind McGuire. McGuire to Wagner. No. Rainbows hold him out. Walter Briggs fired up from his position in the secondary. Maeva was there. Also Colson helping out. Second down, goal to go. And the ball on the 2-yard line.
Well, they played this beautifully. You see McLeod had good contain. Briggs really came up from the outside. Just a real solid job. Tressel right there from the safety position. They filled off tackle on the goal line about as well as you'd want.
Again, the double tight end alignment. Wing back is Slack. Single setback is Wagner. McGuire looking into the end zone for Slack. Out of bounds. Slack was hit into the rail down there by Joaquin Barnett.
excuse me, I'll get this out here. McGuire just too late in that pattern. Slack was able to slip through and actually beat the coverage. McGuire didn't see him till too late, and he actually just ran himself out of bounds.
San Diego State likes to go with that little counter boot to McGuire. That time didn't work.
Interesting stat right here in the first quarter. Now you can see that Hawaii has been extremely tough against all opponents in not giving up touchdowns in the first quarter.
Jimmy Ray and Robert Claiborne are to the far side. In motion is Gelbreth. They overload the right side. Third down, goal to go. McGuire, he's hit. He's sacked. Tally, Barnett.
Oh, let's take a look and see who gets here first. They got a good blitz going. Odom up the middle. Barnett right there is first guy to him. Great penetration. You can see the way the Hawaii defense opened up the lanes for the linebackers. And again, they hold on third down, forcing a field goal attempt.
Field goal attempt by Andy Trakas. 3 out of 6 in field goals. His longest, 26 yards. The ball right there at the 16. This is a 26-yarder for Trakas. Low snap. The kick is up. It is wide to the right. San Diego State does not score.
If you wanted to get this crowd on its feet early on, what a great way to start the ball game.
9:31 left to play in the first quarter. It remains San Diego State and Hawaii scoreless.
At Chevron, you can get everything you need to get you where you're going.
Mommy, Daddy,
even gasoline. Chevron, we're with you all the way.
There is a place unlike any other.
The Coyote.
From Honolulu to Kahului.
The Coyote.
The widest auto selections anywhere in Hawaii.
The Coyote.
Quality, integrity, excellence.
The Coyote.
The ideal place to shop. 14 automotive lines, over 4,000 cars.
The Coyote.
When I was a little girl, my grandfather grew beautiful orchids. But nobody buys our orchids now because of them. Today is what counts. I fly United not because it has roots deep in Hawaii, but because today it has more flights to more cities on both sides of the Pacific. Have you noticed? In business, it's what have you done for me lately?
United, the business airline of Hawaii. Come fly the friendly skies.
Sports medicine. It's a way of keeping someone who loves the game in the game.
Welcome back to Aloha Stadium in Honolulu. San Diego State and Hawaii no score. Rainbows holding off San Diego State after a golden opportunity went awry and a field goal try went to the right. Pitched to the near side. Carrying the ball is Dane MacArthur. And MacArthur gets ushered out of bounds by Kevin Drayton, number 26, the senior out of Pomona, California, and Citrus Junior College. We want to welcome all of our viewers on Prime Ticket in California, Arizona, and Nevada. Just coming over from watching the hockey game, Edmonton 6 and the LA Kings 5. Here, no score, 9:24 left to play in the first quarter. Roscoe to the far side, and to the near side is Conn Smith. Lamar Young, the single setback behind Garrett Gabriel, second down and 5 from the 25. Gabriel keeping, has a hole, has the first down, out to the 32-yard line. Larry Maxey wrote him down. First down of the game for the Rainbow.
And getting that triple option on the way tonight, that's what has to happen for Hawaii. Garrett Gabriel has got to factor into the ground game.
I talked to Garrett earlier this week. He's very aware that San Diego State knows that running the ball is not his strength. He expects the Aztecs to take away the pitch man and force him to run. That time Garrett shows them that might not be always the wisest decision.
First down for the Rainbows on the 33-yard line. Gabriel keeps to the 35. Gabriel to the 41. Good gain on the play. Garrett showing his decision-making ability. Larry Maxey again, a redshirt freshman out of San Diego, California, went to Morse High in 1987 and gained 1,300 yards on offense.
That is Walter Brooks, you know? He's such a good-looking guy. I can't believe he thought we paid to get that thing done. Four. Well, you know, be proud of your number, right? Rah, rah, rah. Be proud of your school, be proud of your number.
Second down and two for the Rainbows at their own 41. Jamal Farmer now is in at single setback. Ball is given to Farmer. First down and more. To midfield. Almost broke it. He was in the grasp of Larry Maxey. Maxey had him by the ankle and did not let go.
And Maxey's the one who just saved the touchdown, too. If Farmer was able to get one leg away, he was on his way. Good look at the replay right now. A little power football up inside. Just good blocking. You see the green shirts just putting the white in the ground. Springs Farmer to the outside. Maxey just trips him up. Good looking football play that time by Hawaii.
So Farmer out over 350 yards now. That was his 67th carry of the year. He has scored 9 touchdowns. First down for the Rainbows for the first time in San Diego State territory at the San Diego State 49. Gabriel Keats now pitches back. Mahuka plays it on the bounce and just gets back to the line of scrimmage, and that was dangerous. And that's an understatement.
That's a case where that ball came right up to Clayton Mahuka. Could have been a costly turnover for the Rainbows. Garrett that time took a hit before he got rid of the ball. Should have got rid of it a little sooner and kept his eye on the pitch man.
But even if he had pitched it, Wesselman, who comes over ultimately to make the tackle, Mahuka was in good relationship and covered the off, covering the option. So San Diego State, having gone to school against the Air Force in the season opener on how to defend the option, had people in the right place at the right time that time.
7:24 left in the first quarter. Second down and 10 from the 49. Gabriel pitches to Dane MacArthur. MacArthur to the 45 of San Diego State. And Johnny Walker, with help from his friendly white shirts, they're making the tackle, gain on the play of 4. That will bring up third down and 6 for the Rainbows. Rainbows have an extraordinary team effort going into this game. 17 players have carried the ball at least once on the offense, and 11 have received passes. And yet, no player has gone over 100 yards in a game. Farmer remains in at the single setback. Third down. Gabriel throws over the middle, crossing pattern. Flags fly, usually there, it's holding. Was intended for MacArthur, incomplete.
Well, Hawaii was in a third and long that time, probably third and 7, close to third and 7. I think a predictable passing situation. San Diego State came with a blitz, and somebody had to reach out to hold.
Gene Wirtz, the umpire, signifies holding. Take a look at Kalele'iki here, number 52. Kalele'iki, yeah.
Oh, I don't know about that. You can't do that, Kalani. It's almost a tackle is what it is.
Kalele'iki had the shirt of Pio Sangapolotelli.
They ought to have that. You know, there's holding and then there's tackling. Tackling by the offensive line.
There's holding and then there's holding on.
Yeah.
Here's Kyle Alou in to punt. He averages 44.6, longest punt of the year, 55 yards. And that was against Utah. Gilbreth is deep. Good punt, angling for the corner, and out of bounds. And they will have to line it up. And still lining it up. It is out all the way to the 19, to the 20. And finally, that's where San Diego State will put it in play. No score. 6:24 left, first quarter.
I was always a quarterback's favorite target. I never dropped the ball because I had hands like glue. And even after football, I stick with my favorite beer, Miller Lite. I don't want some watered-down version of a regular beer. I want the less filling beer that tastes great.
White. Not again.
Thanks, Danny.
Thank you, Dwight.
Nice. There's no catch. When it's Miller Lite, less filling tastes great.
Sometimes, the idea of ditching school, getting a job, and making some bucks can look pretty good. But if you think staying in school till you graduate seems like forever, hang in there. Because getting a good job without a diploma is going to feel like a lifetime. A message from the Hawaii Carpenters Union.
Building a better Hawaii for folks like you and me.
I've got two words for you. Sourdough. sourdough makes it taste like no other burger.
Sourdough.
The new grilled sourdough burger at Jack in the Box.
Sourdough.
A juicy burger, bacon, cheese on sourdough at Jack in the Box. For exciting new taste, this is the place.
Just two words. Sourdough. Where's that one?
There you see the offensive comparisons. Hawaii with the edge in rushing. San Diego State with the edge in passing. And there you see the fumbles lost. Rainbows lead the Western Athletic Conference in turnover margin. First down, ball at the 20-yard line. Ball is given to Wagner. Wagner is able to get out to the 23-yard line. And Odom, Mark Odom is there, along with Dana Directo.
You know what Wagner has? He has with all the great backs that he has that quick acceleration and the ability to run it right up inside. You can see that. Doesn't sidestep at all. He just knifes it right in there.
UCLA winning tonight over Arizona State in the Pac-10, 33-14, the final. So the Bruins coming away with a big win. Second down, a little less than 5 yards to go. Claiborne and Ray are flanked to the right side. The ball is pitched to Wagner to the near side. Good block. Wagner with the first down out to the 32-yard line. And Kim McLeod, number 19, finally ankle tackled him there. First down for San Diego State. So Wagner, only a freshman, and he comes in with now over 70 carries and close to 400 yards. He has scored 7 touchdowns. He is 3rd in the WAC and 31st in the nation in rushing. Claiborne and Ray to the far side, and on the wing to the far side is Gilbert. So triple wide receiver at 1st and 10 from the 33-yard line for San Diego State. No score, first quarter. McGuire sacked for the second time. And that time it was Augie Apelu, number 91.
Well, that's one way to play against trips. Just sack the quarterback. And the Bulls actually did a nice job of locking in there on the receivers. But you can see right now this rush is so quick. They're right there. Apelu gets to him so fast, he can't do anything.
The Aztecs on offense are a little different in their offensive blocking schemes than is, say, Utah. If you rush 5, which Hawaii generally does, they'll keep 6 or sometimes 7 at home. They only give up 1.5 sacks a game.
They've already been sacked twice just tonight.
Second down 16 from the 27 for San Diego State. They are blitzing. The pitch comes to slack. He is grabbed by Barnett at the line of scrimmage.
I tell you, in the last 4 games, Joaquin Barnett has risen to a whole different level as a college football player. He has just been absolutely outstanding. Going back to the Wyoming game, and here we see a blitz now by Odom up inside, but Joaquin's got the responsibility from inside out to play that play. He does it beautifully. I'm going to say it again. I think Hawaii has a real definite edge in team speed with the defense versus this offense.
Barnett with 1 sack already tonight leads the team in tackles. That was his 54th of the season. 3rd and 16 from the 27. Again, triple wide receivers to the right side for San Diego State. And McGuire to throw. Steps up, throws over the middle. It is incomplete. There was some bumping going on. Both players turn for the ball. Ray, number 17, the intended receiver, and covering him was Briggs.
Step for step. Step for step. I think Walt had excellent position on him as we watched Jimmy Ray run off the field.
Jimmy Ray wanted a flag. He looked around at the officials. Jimmy Ray has an excellent lineage for football. His father was a Michigan State quarterback back in the 60s. He comes from a very good bloodline for football.
I wonder if my kids will be known like that.
Joe Santos deep. Joe Santos, the punter, kicks it. Coming up to take it is Seidner. Calls for the fair catch at the last moment. Fumbles the ball. A penalty flag and a big pileup.
I think he might, well, I don't know if he was interfered with or not, but the flag went down so quick at the time he dropped the ball. We'll take a look at it. I didn't see a player make contact, but you would think that might be the kind of penalty. Let us see with the magic eye. And you can tell a San Diego State player didn't look on too happy.
Interference, San Diego State.
That is a break for Hawaii.
35-yard punt.
I think they're saying he didn't touch him, but you've got to give the player room. They're saying he got right in his sight lines. He did not give him the room to make the fair catch.
Here's Gene Wirtz.
We have catch interference against the kicking team. 5-yard penalty. First down.
Well, I think, Bobby, based on what we saw in the replay, that must have been the call. Because, again, I didn't see the contact either. And, you know, when you see the guys covering tight like that, that's really a tough call. That's real subjective, I think, you know.
And you can see Al Luganville thinks it's a subjective call. He thinks he's getting homered there.
3:49 left to play in the first quarter. No score between Hawaii and San Diego State. Hawaii will have the ball first down at the 42-yard line.
One of the nice things about coming home is things are still the same. Even my dad.
How's business?
He still does things the same way.
Well, I hope we have this all on computer.
Yes, we can make our lives a little better.
Are those a little expensive?
I am finished my work.
Oh, yes, we can touch and help the lives of others.
One company has been helping Hawaiians get to where they want to go for over 100 years. Chevron, we're with you all the way.
Get your team together now for the Eagle Aloha Bowl Hoop It Up Championship. Look for the official entry form in midweek or call the Talking Phone Book for complete details. It's open to men and women of all ages, heights, and skill levels. It's the Eagle Aloha Bowl Hoop It Up, benefiting Hawaii's Special Olympics. Jump to it.
3:49 left to play here in the first quarter. No score, and the Rainbows now will put the ball in play at their own 42-yard line. Jamal Farmer in at the single setback for the Rainbows. Ball is given to Farmer, and Farmer, or is it kept by Gabriel? Gabriel running around the right side, and he did keep the ball, did not fake it. He faked us, I'll tell you that. Well, over the 45 to the 46.
You were obviously fake. Bobby and I saw him with the football. But anyway, I think, you know, not to pat ourselves on the back up here, I think we've got it down pretty much on how they're going to play it. They double-teamed up inside to stop the dive. They were out there in the pitch. They're going to force Gabriel to run the football.
Derek Branch to the near side. Double wide receiver to the left. Second down and 7 from the 46. Gabriel to throw. Has time. And a sideline pattern complete to Ahuna to the 35. That's enough for a first down. Larry Maxey covered on the play for San Diego State. Good protection that time for the quarterback, Gabriel.
Really the key there, Jimmy. The protection was excellent. They let Ahuna get into the pattern. He goes against the zone nicely, gets open. Maxey in pursuit, but Dan picks up 19 big ones.
Sean Olivotto back in the game now at center, replacing Kalani Kalele'iki.
Yeah, he went out with a twisted right ankle, they said, but he'll be okay. Looks like they did a pretty heavy tape job on him.
Roscoe to the left, and Derek Branch to the right. Jamal Farmer remains at single setback. Ahuna and MacArthur in the slot. Again, Gabriel to throw. Throws. It is complete to MacArthur. 20. MacArthur to the 16, and now the Rainbows are threatening.
This is what Paul Johnson, the offensive coordinator from Hawaii, loves to do. Come out, they dance with you a couple of sets, now to give you a little bit of motion, they mix some people up, and they go to work on the zone, they create some confusion, and there you see Dane, and the nice thing about that is that Garrett read the secondary very well.
Maxey and Moses, Clark Moses, number 28 on the spot for San Diego State. First down for the Rainbows of Hawaii at the 16-yard line of the Aztecs. Roscoe to the left, Derek Branch to the right. Again, Jamal Farmer, the single setback. Four-man front for San Diego State. The ball is kept by Gabriel. Dances. Gabriel looking for the pitch, and he runs right into Moses.
Well, we mentioned it before. Garrett might as well not even look for the pitch man. They are leaving Garrett alone. He's just got to make it happen. He makes that guy miss. He might be in the end zone, but still a nice game for Hawaii. The Aztecs are going to have to rethink that. You can't leave Gabriel by himself.
Well, I don't know. I think that they rethought that all week long. They looked at the strength of the fullback position and how prolific it's been thus far this season. They looked at the pitch guys and how effective they've been, and they said, hey, the quarterback has not been the big element. Let's take the other two away and see what he can do.
I said Moses. This was Drayton with the tackle for San Diego State. Again, Gabriel DeFroy. Throws wide open as MacArthur off his hand. MacArthur had to turn around. But boy, was he open. He was strolling along in an artificial meadow.
Great call. He made the wrong move. I think Garrett a little bit frustrated. Hard to say whether Garrett threw the ball in the wrong place or Dane made the wrong break in the pattern.
So tough to make this catch. You see Dane MacArthur had to do a 180. Tough to get your orientation and just outside his grasping fingertips.
Gabriel now 2 for 6 in passing. Third down for the Rainbows. A ball advanced inside the 15-yard line to the 13. Third down and 6. The ball Farmer with a single setback. Big play here. Farmer fakes the play action to, rather, Gabriel fakes the play action, tries to hit Ahuna. Ahuna held up by Larry Maxey. Well, that is incomplete. That will bring a fourth down, and we will see Jason Elam.
People are booing because of exactly what you just said, Jim. Maxey sort of held him up, but I don't think that the ball was ruled as catchable, therefore no interference. Take a look. Now, there's definitely some contact here before the ball's there, but the ball, as you see, really goes out of bounds by a big margin.
Alou will hold. Lemoy Tour will snap. The ball is at the 20, 30-yard field goal by Jason Elam. Elam in field goals, 7 for 8. This should be a chip shot for him. It is up. It is good. Rainbows break on top. 2 minutes exactly left to play in the first quarter. And the Rainbows score on a 30-yard field goal by Jason Elam. I want to remind everyone that at the conclusion of tonight's game, we will be selecting the GTE Hawaiian Tel Rainbow Most Valuable Player. The University of Hawaii General Scholarship Fund will benefit in the name of that player from Hawaiian Tel. So we have seen, unlike in the weeks previous here at Aloha Stadium, we have seen a very tenacious first half on the part of both teams. Both teams trying to take advantage of what the other team gives them. San Diego State with a golden opportunity. All the way down to the 2-yard line. First and goal at the 2. They were unable to score. And they missed a 26-yard field goal by Andy Trakas. Rainbows come marching down the field. They stall. 30-yard field goal by Jason Elam. And that is the difference.
One person, that one little advantage for the Rainbows tonight. Jason Elam, very familiar with kicking off artificial turf. Trakas, on the other hand, for San Diego State, doesn't get a chance to kick on artificial turf. They play on natural grass. They don't see much of it. A little bit of an adjustment, and you can see one made field goal for the Rainbows, one missed field goal for the Aztecs.
Yeah, well, as an old defensive coach, the goal is to only let him kick off once a game anyway.
Claiborne and Wagner deep. And the kick by Elam. That will drift out of bounds. 5-yard penalty. And Elam will kick off from the 30.
There you go, Bobby, showing your expertise once again as he kicks it out of bounds. It was a good comment, though. It was a good comment. Welcome to the broadcast booth, Rodman. There you take a look at Bob Wagner. He didn't like that because he knows field position is real key. San Diego State throughout this first quarter has looked good on offense, especially on a few plays there. 5 yards can make a big difference. Garrett Gabriel. Very intense young man. I think has improved week in and week out thus far this season.
Garrett Gabriel seems to be one of those players that has that rare quality. He's able to imbue the players around him with confidence. He exudes confidence himself. He's been a winner at every level. I think that's his strength more than a wealth of physical talent.
Well, he wouldn't be the first quarterback to lead a team to great success with that particular strength.
Claiborne and Wagner again deep. Now Elam kicks off from the 30. Again drifting toward the sideline, and it is taken by Claiborne. He is hit and fumbles the ball. San Diego State has it at the 15. San Diego State able to hold on. That may have been the hit of the season.
Well, I think you can watch football all season long and you won't see anybody do better than Sean Abreu right here, right now, full sprint, I mean head on. That is totally reckless football. Great effort by Sean Abreu, number 40 from Hawaii.
And Robert Claiborne will be feeling that when he gets into his plane seat tomorrow night.
So Abreu really unloaded on Claiborne. The ball is at the 14. San Diego State trailing 3-0 on the field goal by Elam. And they put the ball in play at the 14-yard line. Triple wide receivers to the right. Claiborne, who bounced right back up from that hit. Ray and Gilbert. McGuire to Ray. Through behind him. incomplete. Seemed to hurry the pass a bit.
Well, I think they need that quick game because they're really afraid now. Afraid is the wrong word, but Hawaii has shown their ability to stunt against them. They opened up with the quick game. They want to go back to it. McGuire, I think, a little bit rattled as you looked at his stats right there, 2 for 7.
And you talked about he's been sacked twice already. He's only been sacked a time and a half a game. He's already aware that the Hawaii defense can get back there near him. That can cause any quarterback to rush a throw.
Wagner, the single setback. Darren Wagner, again, triple wide receiver to the right. Now Wagner goes in motion, no setback, passing formation. McGuire throws to Wagner. Fingertip catch, escorted out of bounds by Joaquin Barnett. Short gain of the play from the line of scrimmage, the 14, up to the 17. That will bring up 3rd down and 7 for San Diego State with 1:44 left in the first quarter. 3-0 Rainbow.
This is what Hawaii wanted. Talking with Rich Ellison earlier was to try to, if you take a look at Darren Wagner's stats, I mean, already he's off to a great career only as a freshman. But what they wanted to do is put San Diego State into predictable situations just like this so they could take advantage of them.
3rd down, again, the same formation, 3rd and 7. McGuire throws long, tries to lead Claiborne. What a catch at midfield! What a catch by Claiborne! That ball put in there perfectly by McGuire.
Wow, what a pass. Talk about taking advantage. Boy, they didn't mess around that time. There we saw why McGuire is being rated by a lot of people as perhaps the best passing quarterback. And we've seen some good ones in Mitchell and Leach. But McGuire right now with just the perfect touch.
And James Burton is not far away from Claiborne. He's there. That ball had to be right on the money. And it was about 35 yards in the air. McGuire right on time.
1st down for San Diego State as the Aztecs come roaring back here in the final 1:38 of the first quarter. 1st down from the Rainbow, 47-yard line. Ball is given to Slack. He gets to the 45, and then he is hit head-on by Joaquin Barnett. So Barnett coming up with another tackle. Barnett from Carson, California. 232-pound junior. In on the play of 2, 2nd down and 8 for San Diego State. Slack so far, you see his production here in this game. Claiborne and Ray. Claiborne number 2, Ray number 17 to the far side. And again on the wing is Gilbert. Gilbert, the leading pass receiver in the conference. Again, Wagner goes in motion. Rainbow's almost offside. Now the flag is thrown. Crossing pattern incomplete. They will chase the ball, but no possession there. And the Rainbows, I believe, will be called for being offside or encroachment. Unless, of course, somebody on San Diego State moved. And I think the Rainbows will be called this time.
That was really a free play too for San Diego State, so they were pretty smart and just keeping it going. Well, Al Luganville's kind of a nervous kind of guy, but he's just all over these officials. He's real talker down there. Kind of what you call an expressive football coach in psychological terms.
That moves the ball to the Rainbow 40. 2nd down and 3. Triple wide receivers again to the right. Colson picks up Claiborne. Addison is watching Ray. Wagner, single setback. McGuire, sweep to Wagner. Hit by Maeva at the 40-yard line. No gain on the play. That will bring up 3rd down and 3. Rainbow's reading that very well.
David Maeva does a nice job on this play of not over-pursuing. He stays at home. When Wagner cuts back, he's in excellent position to make the stop.
Well, if I could add one thing, I think Joaquin Barnett, too, is real key in that because he had the position of contain. He turned it into Maeva because he just took on the wall of blockers that were in front, forcing him to cut back into Maeva. Great play by defense.
McGuire now 4 for 9, 53 yards. 3rd down and 3. Ball just inside the Rainbow 40. Short drop. McGuire throws up the sideline for Ray. That will be intercepted by Briggs. He steps out of bounds at the 13-yard line.
And on this play again, you can give some of the credit to the defensive line. In fact, most of it. They got to McGuire just as he releases this ball. Watch this stick. That takes it off. A little something off his throw. He's short. Walter Briggs playing center field. Reads it nicely. Comes in and makes the pick.
That is the 5th interception of the year for Walter Briggs. He had 1 against Tulane, 1 against Long Beach State, 2 against Utah, and 1 tonight against San Diego State.
Well, as David Stant, who makes the sack right here, not the sack, but the real heavy rush on McGuire, gets there, Briggs, as you said, played it free, timed it beautifully, and then you could really see Walter Briggs' athletic ability as he just kept his feet in bounds. Great effort.
Good ball, Farmer. Farmer trying to power out over the 15-yard line to the 16. Gain on the play of approximately 3 yards. Second down and about seven. There you see Walter Briggs. Walter with 5 interceptions. That's the end of the first quarter. Hawaii 3, San Diego State nothing.
Just in the nick of time, Bulova watches at JCPenney. JCPenney has a large selection of famous Bulova watches, perfect to keep today's active men and women on time. Handsome Bulova watches for men, stylish designs for women, durable diver watches for deep water adventure, smart styles for the scholar, sporty watches for the athlete. Head into JCPenney and strap on a famous Bulova watch today.
You're looking smarter than ever at JCPenney.
Still looking for a good deal on a 1989 car or truck? Well, look no further. We've still got the coolest deal of the year. Choose any 89 car or truck at a great low price, and we'll give you free air conditioning and a free vehicle protection package that includes rust proofing, paint sealant, and more. All combined to save you thousands of dollars. Flock down to your Toyota Hawaii dealers now, while the 89s are still cool.
No matter how careful you are, accidents do happen. And when they do, you need help. Shudder and Glickstein.
On the all-new Fox Monday Night. First, it's love.
I'm asking you to marry me.
Then, suspicion.
There's no way she's in this.
You know that?
Peter DeLuise, 21 Jump Street. Then, no matter where you're from, it's tough to be a parent.
And the answers are not in this Mr. Spock book.
It's Dr. Spock. Mr. Spock's one of you guys.
Alien Nation, the series, right after 21 Jump Street.
First quarter statistics, rushing yards, Rainbows 47, San Diego State 27. There you see the passing yards. And the Rainbows will put the ball in play here. At the start of the second quarter, leading 3-0 over San Diego State. Second down, 7.5. Ball is kept by Gabriel, trying to get outside. They chase him down, fumbles the ball. It goes out of bounds. And credit Clayton Mahuka. We're getting there and getting a hand on it as it tumbled out of bounds out over the 25-yard line. They will give him forward progress and the fumble as you experience it again. Mahuka comes up and he's able to get a hand on it.
I wonder if they would have ruled Garrett down, because when he hits the turf that the ball pounces out like that.
That may have been.
And Garrett's been effective thus far on the ground game when he carries it himself. You saw the graphic, 6 carries for 31 yards. That's 5 yards a pop. That's not shabby.
Gabriel, 3 for 7, 69 yards. And McGuire, 4 for 10. He's had 1 interception. He has 54 yards in passing. Gabriel able to carry out for the first down.
That's what they did. They ruled the ball down, Jim, when he first went down. And then they decided to measure it, made it a little bit sticky. And there's a good look at Walter Briggs as they shine his head. I know that feeling, Walter. That's good. Being bald is beautiful.
First down for the Rainbows. The ball just short of the 25-yard line. 14:53 left to play in the first half.
I noticed you kept away from that comment, James,
about
being bald.
Well, you know, I have the same problem. Yeah. Same problem. Derek Branch to the near side. And to the far side is Conn Smith. Jamal Farmer, the single setback. Back to pass, Gabriel, looking for Conn Smith. Throwing long, he has a step. He has the ball!
That's just, Larry, you go up the sideline, I'm going to throw it to you. I think, first of all, Garrett gets excellent protection. He's looking at Larry Conn Smith. This is a one-pattern receiver right now. All the way, Larry has to almost wait for the ball. He had 2 steps on his defender. Nice execution.
Paul Johnson's mentioned they're trying to get Larry Conn-Smith to be a bigger part of the offense. He's got such good speed, he can run by guys. Proved it right there.
That's his longest reception of the season. In fact, that's only his second pass reception of the season. So now the Rainbows have the ball at the 38-yard line of San Diego State. 14:35 left to play in the first half. 3-0 Rainbows. Ball is pitched on the reverse of the near side. Carrying the ball is Seidner to the 20. He may score. Down he goes at the 5. I said Seidner. That was Conn-Smith. Conn-Smith again.
Well, if you want to work a guy into the offense, I couldn't think of two better plays. First, you hit him on the deep go pattern, and then you come right back to him, and you go with the reverse, and Larry's showing the kind of condition and the kind of speed he has. Excellent play by Larry Conn-Smith.
Conn-Smith can do some nice things once he gets the ball. He'll pick his lane right here, go up the middle, very nearly breaks it loose, and only a sharp ankle tackle here brings him down.
John Wesselman saved the touchdown for San Diego State. So Larry Conn-Smith, all of a sudden, has become a big factor in this game. And the Rainbows have first and goal to go at the 5. They come out in their power eye formation. Ball is given to Jamal Farmer. And Farmer inside the 5 to approximately the 3-yard line.
You know, it's really good to see a guy like Larry Conn-Smith starting to factor into this offense here, Jim, because he has been a little bit frustrated through 5 ball games. Excellent kickoff returner. Has really been used sort of as a decoy in the offense thus far. And you saw what he's capable of. And that really takes a lot of pressure off of a guy like Chris Roscoe once they can start to get a guy like Conn-Smith into the offense like that.
That particular play has been successful with Seidner running it. And that time they went with Conn-Smith. Second down, goal to go. Again, Farmer to the 1. Sunga Pulotelli, number 98. Eric Duncan there for San Diego State. Cy Neal from Oceanside, California, number 12. Tracy Mao from Linwood, California. The name like Mao, you know what his nickname is on the team?
Chairman.
Chairman, yes. Third down, goal to go for the Rainbows. I mean, this is like deja vu, only you flip-flop the team. San Diego State was down here in the last quarter, and they came up empty. And the Rainbows now face third down and a little more than a yard. They come out again in that power eye. Nu'uanu Kaulia, Manly Williams, number 66. Two defensive players for blocking purposes, and Jamal Farmer. Farmer leaping, touchdown!
You know, the Bows that time, and they got within the goal line right there, just going to play smash football. 3 successive plays. Now they really come with the surge, all the power, everybody. Jamal takes the big leap. I mean, that's good old-fashioned football, baby. 1, 2, 3, we're in the end zone.
Elam in to try the extra point for the Rainbows. 12:35 left to play in the first half. Trying to make it 10-0, and he drills it. Hawaii 10, San Diego State nothing. And the player, Larry Conn-Smith.
I really appreciate this, Bobby.
I hate these blind dates.
I know it's my boss's daughter, but you might like her.
Dad, you the car.
Dad or Dad? No matter where you're going.
There's no gas.
Or what you're going
Dad?
Through. At Chevron, in one quick stop, you can get high-octane Chevron Supreme and everything you need to help turn a night like this into a night like this.
Hello.
Oh, Daddy. Hello.
Chevron, we're with you all the way.
The pain is unbearable at times. It's just sometimes I can't even get out of bed in the morning. It hurts so bad. It's an awful, terrible disease. I'm 22, and you think of osteoarthritis as being an old person's disease. Look at me. It's not.
Put your money where it will work the hardest.
More entrees like our fresh salads, more snacks like our juicy chicken burgers, more treats like our creamy shakes and luscious sundaes, more variety, more menu, a whole lot more at the Colonel's New Image Restaurants.
That's right, cross the road, Jack. Kentucky Fried Chicken's got more.
You'll love our 6 New Image Restaurants.
Jamal Farmer, his 10th touchdown of the season. But he will be the first to tell you that the play of Larry Conn Smith set up that possibility. Robert Claiborne and Darren Wagner deep for San Diego State. Rainbows leading 10-0. And Jason Elam setting the ball up on the near hash mark on the 35-yard line. That was the 31st touchdown of the year by the Rainbow. Elam comes forward. And it will go to Claiborne in the deep corner. Takes it on the 4-yard line. Claiborne trying to find running room, and they pinch him as he crosses the 20. Out to the 22. Some after the whistle jostling going on. 18-yard return.
I think this is really an interesting graphic. You talk about team, the notion of team effort. There you see it right now in 31 touchdowns, 16 different plays. Look at how the University of Hawaii, the spread offense, Paul Johnson's play calling, the substitution, how they've got their team into the game, and then you've got four by the defense. You look at San Diego State now, even though they have a tremendous offense as far as national ranking, they only have 19 touchdowns, and the playing has been somewhat limited.
McGuire gives it to Slack, trying to find running room. He's chased down from behind by Herman Talley. Also, Maeva came over from the middle, and Joaquin Barnett from the outside. So the line of scrimmage, the 23-yard line, and Slack able to maneuver it up over the 25 to the 26, second and 7.
Go back to that graphic there. Just one last editorial comment. It's interesting that San Diego State would be ranked third in the nation, but not as prolific in the end zone scoring points, and that's what really counts. It's the old end zone versus entertainment zone. It only counts when you get it over the goal line.
11:55 left to play in the first half. 10-0 Rainbow. Pitch to Slack. Slack to the 30. Slack very close to the first down as he gets out to the 32. David Maeva. Maeva out of Kailua and Kamehameha. First team all whack in 1988. Number 31 for the Rainbows there to make the stop. And Slack running very well. In fact, his first career touchdown for San Diego State came against the Rainbows in 1987 right here on this turf.
Ron Slack, a very different kind of runner than is Darren Wagner. Ron Slack is a shake and baker. He puts a lot of moves on you, doesn't have quite the speed that Wagner has, is not as strong, but better at making guys miss. They like to run him wide.
A shake and baker? That's a good one. I thought a shake and baker is when you put that stuff on the chicken and stuff, and you know, you kind of stick it in the oven, but that's good. I like
you've
that.
You've spent a lot of time alone in a room.
I've been a lot of kitchens by myself late night, you know. Like the stuff.
Ball is out to the 32-yard line, about a yard short of the first down. That will bring up third down now for San Diego State, third and a yard. Gilbert comes out for a breather. He is really a designated game breaker. Ray to the right, Claiborne to the left. And Darren Wagner now on third down and short yardage. Rainbows wedging in toward the middle. McGuire, quarterback sneak. Maybe short. Maybe short.
And when you're 6'8 and you don't make it, it's about a yard and a half to go on the sneak. That tells you the defense had excellent penetration.
Well, Gene Wirth is already signaling the first down.
Well, I really thought Hawaii stuffed them that time. I'm surprised they got the benefit of the mark.
And they will not measure.
Take a look at the recto. Pretty good coming in there now. They get low. McGuire goes high, but I don't think Steve McGuire really makes very much forward progress. He like lays on top of the pile. I don't mean to sound like we're just cheering for the guys in green. I just think they get the benefit of a real good mark that time.
First down for San Diego State at the 34-yard line. Rainbow showing blitz. Colson right up on the line, the cornerback. Now no setback as Wagner goes in motion. McGuire throws, coming back for the ball and dropping it, actually, is Claiborne. Claiborne caught the ball low and then hit it with his thigh pad, and it tumbled loose. Incomplete, second down and 10.
The Rainbows, while not sacking Dan McGuire, again getting some pressure on him. The ball thrown a little low makes it a tougher grab for Claiborne than it otherwise might have been. That was their concern, San Diego State. How quick are the Rainbow backers? Will they be able to get into the backfield?
Claiborne and Ray to the far side. Burton picks up Claiborne. Addison looks at Ray. Addison and also Burton, only freshmen. Slack is now the single setback. McGuire throws. Oh, open is Gilbreth. Gilbreth and Maeva collide. Gilbreth holds on at the 49-yard line of the Rainbows. Excellent catch by Gilbreth.
That's that little counter boot they like to use, Jim. Dan McGuire will have his back to the play for just a moment. Then he'll look downfield. He'll turn around, come against the grain. Nice pass. Actually, a little behind Gilbreth. If it had been thrown ahead of him, he might have been off to the races.
Well, that was helmet to helmet that time. Excellent catch by Gilbreth as he holds on. The Wax leading receiver, and you can see why. First down. They will put the ball down just inside the Rainbow 49. Rainbows lead 10 to nothing. We are in the second quarter. 10:50 left to play in the first half. Slack again, the single setback. Triple wide receiver to the left for San Diego State. First and 10. This is Slack. Slight hole. Able to wedge from the 49. Close to the 45-yard line. They unpile. Dana Directo. Manley Williams in the game now, number 66. And David Stant, number 96. Ball short of the 45. Second down for San Diego State. Slack goes out, and Darren Wagner, number 22, the freshman, back in the game at single setback. Claiborne is flanked to the far side. In the slot is Gilbert. To the near side is Ray. Second down. McGuire looking for Claiborne. He is free. Gets it at the 35-yard line. Burton grabs him, and Claiborne takes him for a ride all the way down to the 25.
Boy, excellent play all the way around that time at San Diego State. First of all, it's probably the best job of pass protection so far for McGuire, and allows him to get into one of the deeper patterns we've seen tonight thus far. And there you see it right all over there. He just hits him. Claiborne all alone. I think Bowes were in zone. Burton was out there trying to play soft, but he really had the time to deliver it, and Dan McGuire did.
And you can see it's 6'8". Dan McGuire has great vision. You give him time, he's got the arm to pick you apart.
First and 10 from the 26-yard line. McGuire on a sweep to Wagner. Gets by Talley. Hit by a payload. Down he goes. Loss of a yard on the play.
Go back to that team speed on defense. Hawaii pursuing to the football very, very well, particularly on the running plates to the outside. That kid right there, Herm Talley's really come along this year. Going back, that he wasn't a name that we had figured in or going into the season as being a big player. And Herm Talley has just stepped up to the plate and made himself known in this football team.
McGuire, 6 for 13, one interception, 90 yards now. Last week, he was 24 for 37, almost 600 yards, 570 against Utah. Second down and 12. Ball out at the 28-yard line. Triple wide receiver to the right. McGuire looking, throws, Claiborne. Claiborne with a great move, trying to get outside, inside the 20 to the 17. Briggs Colson there. That is short of the first down. They have to go just short of the 15 for the first down.
Robert Claiborne, second in receptions on this team, but he and his partner Gilbreth, both very reliable. Both of them can hurt you after they catch the ball. Claiborne almost got away.
Third down and one for San Diego State. Slack back in is the single setback. McGuire to throw. Throws. It is incomplete. It was intended for Ray. Ray, a post pattern at the 5-yard line.
McGuire, you can see right there, real disappointed with himself. That had 6 points written all over. Post pattern right there, had the break, had the step on the defender. That young man right there just threw it behind him. He knows it.
And that is fourth down. And we will see Andy Trakas out of San Diego and Patrick Henry High School. Jimmy Ray will hold. Zy Pepin, rather Zy Perrin, will be the snapper. Ball is down at the 24. 34-yard attempt. Longest attempt of the year. It is up. Boy, he put his leg to that one, and it is good. So San Diego State gets on the board. They come back here in quarter number two. 8:26 left to play. It is 10-3 Rainbow.
You know, baseball cards are real popular these days. For one Ron Say, I can get a whole case of my favorite beer, Miller Lite. I don't want some watered-down minor league version of a regular beer. I want the less filling beer that tastes great.
Hey, Ace! Give me two cases, you can have this baby.
Dream on.
One case.
Nope.
A six-pack.
Mm-mm.
Half a can?
The Big League Light beer, Miller Lite, where less filling tastes great.
Okay, I'll give you two cases, and you don't have to take the card. But that's my final offer.
Must have a couple of mine already.
All right. Whoa.
Take the place.
Name the time.
take the time and go.
Go!
Call Robert's Overnighters.
Robert.
Escape to the Kona Surf Resort and Country Club from $195 for two, including round-trip airfare and an air-conditioned car. Extra nights from $75. So why wait?
There's no excuse.
No excuse. I'm out of here.
To celebrate our 25th anniversary in Hawaii, Panasonic offers a new twist on an old adage. With the purchase of a 20-inch stereo television, our top-of-the-line OmniVision VCR, or a family-sized microwave oven, we'll give you one of these handy cooler bags free. So even though you have to pay for your lunch, with a little help from Panasonic, you can cook it better in your new microwave. Enjoy it more in front of your new TV, or just carry it around for free.
Garrett Gabriel, the Rainbow quarterback, trotting into the locker room, and the report is that he has an injured right wrist.
Take a look for Walter Santiago. Given the defensive package, he's warming up on the sidelines that San Diego's using, taking away the pitch man, making the quarterback run. You can be in for a world of shame and pain if you let Walter Santiago jig around in your backfield.
Kickoff by Tom Wirth. Picked up by Larry Consmith. Smith looking for the hole. He finds a hole out over the 25 to the 30. Oh, there were possibilities there. He almost got in the fast lane.
Well, you know, remember, Larry Consmith earlier with a couple of big plays, we talked about his kickoff ability. He was second-team All-American last year as a kickoff return artist, and here you see why, because he's got that great acceleration.
So Walter Santiago now has gone in at quarterback, redshirt freshman out of Haula Oahu, Kahuku High School, 2 of 2 on the year, 41 yards in passing, one touchdown. And now the responsibility of this game falls squarely on this young man's shoulders. Lamar Young is the single setback. First down from the 30. Ball is fumbled, and Santiago goes back to the 25-yard line and falls on the ball.
So often you see when a replacement quarterback's in, just a little exchange problem, a little different cadence, a little different rhythm, problems that usually iron themselves out, but when you're in the shadow of your own goalpost, you don't want to give it up back here.
Well, if I can just put it very simply, warming up on the sideline ain't what we just saw. And that's the unfortunate thing. You just got to get out in the field and get the rhythm of the game going.
Layton Mahuka now in the slot along with Dave MacArthur. Ball is given, no, kept by Santiago. Reads to the 30, turns the corner, up the near sideline, but out of bounds at the 46. There is the quickness of Walter Santiago.
Yeah, and he is a running quarterback. We've been talking all throughout the first half about the pressure on the quarterback to establish the running game, and we've seen San Diego State defensively opt to give the quarterback the game, and now with Walter coming into the game, he is capable of really exploiting that. Take nothing away from Gabriel. Santiago is a very good option running quarterback.
They're going to have to make an adjustment. They're going to have to overplay the run even more than they have been. You just cannot let a quality runner like Walter Santiago loose. He has the capacity to make people miss.
Steve Mutter-Shevitz being helped off the field out of La Puente, California. Jamal Farmer now has gone in at single setback for the Rainbows. First down after that run by Walter Santiago at the Rainbow 46-yard line. Wide receivers left and right. Ball is given to Jamal Farmer. Leaps over a man in the San Diego State secondary. Wrestles with Wesselman and finally succumbs to the pressure.
I think they're going to give Clayton the ball and forward progress. As we saw, Farmer fumbles real late while he was still up trying to break three and four guys. And Mahuka picks up a fumble and a first down, I'm sure. Take a look at it. I like the move by Farmer. Boy, he comes through to, he steps up and he keeps going. Now he just doesn't want to go down. Come on, guys. Six, seven guys. You can't tackle me. And the ball pops up for Clayton right there. Good break for Hawaii.
Good break. Ball is at the 44, inside the 44-yard line of San Diego State. Roscoe to the near side. Leonard Lau to the far side. Ball is again kept by Santiago. He's at the 40. He's at the 34-yard line. Gain of 9, almost 10.
We're seeing it again. The running ability of Walter Santiago on the option with the pitch man covered. He does have no hesitation about tucking that up and going. He can get some yardage on you. It's going to make the San Diego defensive brain trust rethink their strategy.
Well, they may rethink it. The question is, can they make the game adjustment after they've probably been practicing that other thing all week? We'll be interested to see how Hawaii exploits it.
Second down, less than a yard. Farmer. Armour may have the first down as he's wedged to the turf. Cy Neal out of Oceanside, California, number 12, made the tackle for San Diego State. That's enough for a first down. 6:31 left to play in the first half. And the Rainbows leading 10-3. And Walter Santiago, because of the reported injury to Garrett Gabriel, has been pressed into action in this game. The first snap, a fumble, and a 5-yard loss. The second snap, he gets free up the near sidelines for a big game. And now the Rainbows are pressing into go territory. First down. Ball is given to Farmer. Farmer struggles to the 30, rather to the 27, inside the 30. And another good gain on first down for the Rainbows, going behind the blocks of Alan Smith and Leo Goas on the left side. John Wesselman out of San Diego made the stop.
You pointed it out, Jim, and you also Larry Jones, 67, you see in there as well. You know, credit Jamal, credit the offensive line. That's just a good, quick, power football play. Everybody did their job.
Leonard Lau to the right, Chris Roscoe to the left. Walter Santiago. Oh, big hole for Jamal Farmer. First down inside the 20.
Larry Jones just buried somebody at the line of scrimmage. I mean, Larry Jones just threw one of those NFL highlight film blocks. Just a nice job.
Again, John Wesselman on the stop. Big hole.
You see Jones just buried the guy in front of him. I'll tell you, that's great blocking up front.
Same offensive set. Jamal Farmer, the freshman. Santiago follows Farmer to the 10, to the 5, to the 3-yard line. John Wesselman saved another touchdown.
And then went right back up again over Larry Jones up inside that right side of the offensive line. Led by Larry Jones. We'll take a look at it if you can see Jones's block, but that hole opens up. Boy, they're just playing some crushing football up inside on that offensive line.
And now the Rainbows really starting to move San Diego State at the line of scrimmage. That could be a long night for the Aztecs if the Rainbows are continually able to open that kind of hole.
Rainbows will go to their power eye goal line offense now. They have only 7 seconds in which to snap the ball as they come to the line. Kalia, Manley Williams, Farmer. Farmer wedges back to the line of scrimmage. Maybe a yard, maybe.
Well, we haven't seen that much of this particular offense. The only limitation I see to it, particularly when you're about 4 yards out, is the defense overplays you to the inside. They expect that, and that's, you know, you get that massive humanity there. There's nobody out there in the perimeter, but whether the Bulls can operate that way, I don't know.
It's a great offense to get a yard in, tough offense to get four in.
So timeout has been called by the Rainbows. 4 minutes, 41 seconds left to play in the first half. Hawaii threatens. They're knocking. They lead 10-3. Glenn Giardi and Bobby Curran at Aloha Stadium in Honolulu. Glad you're looking in wherever you may be. Rainbows second down, goal to go from the power eye. Kept by Santiago. Pitches back to Nuuanu Kaulia. Touchdown!
You know, you really gotta like Kaulia. A couple of weeks ago, we saw him catch a touchdown where he had a big cast on his arm. He's really a defensive player, a defensive lineman. Here he comes to pitch back in the option. So one thing to catch a touchdown pass, now to take the pitch and power your way into the end zone.
That is his second touchdown. He caught one before. That's number two. And as you mentioned, he's a defensive lineman. Boy, he's got to have a picture of that somewhere to tell his grandchildren. Yeah, I played both ways. Here's Elam. It is good. It is 17 for the Rainbows of Hawaii, 3 for San Diego State. And when you think about this game against San Diego State, you have to think about Walter Santiago. He has come on fire. So Walter Santiago must be very proud of the way he guided this team. I mean, it was a team effort. The blocking of Larry Jones was pointed out. The running of Santiago. Santiago, 3 carries, 55 yards. And so you can see that Walter comes out, and the Rainbows do not drop off in production at all. And they, on that touchdown drive, now lead 17-3 as Nuuanu Kaulia scores on a pitch.
Well, you know, take nothing away from Garrett, take nothing away from Walter Santiago, because his efforts have been superlative. However, the overplaying on the dive of Pickford has really opened up the quarterback, and his fate would have it. Garrett gets hurt, Walter gets a chance to come into the game, and they can exploit that in the defense, and that they do in that one drive.
Elam will kick off for the Rainbows deep. Claiborne and Wagner. It will go to Claiborne inside the five, takes it at the three. Claiborne to the 25. Claiborne ridden down from behind as he gets out to the 28-yard line. 4:29 left. 25-yard kickoff return by Claiborne. Now, San Diego State will try to answer back, and they have the weapons. First of all, Dan McGuire, the quarterback. 7 for 15, 103 yards, and one interception. And then the receiver, Claiborne. And also, they have as the big receiver, Monty Gilbert, and the running of Darren Wagner and Ron Slack. First down from the 28-yard line for San Diego State. Triple wide receiver to the right. Ball is given up the middle. Wagner to the 30, perhaps to the 31. He's wedged to the turf. Gainer directo, Joaquin Barnett. And on the stop for the Rainbows, 4:18, and the clock starts to run down here in the first half.
Talking to Aztec offensive coordinator Dave Lay, he said that there's no way that San Diego State can afford to be one-dimensional against Hawaii. They're going to have to be able to move it on the ground, otherwise they could be in for a long night.
Rainbows again showing a six-man front. Colson, the cornerback, right up behind the line. Wagner, the single setback. Wagner now changes position. Triple wide receiver to the left. McGuire, short drop, throws. It is complete. Circling back is Gilbert. Gilbreth to the 40. Gilbreth is cut down by Treffler. Gilbreth tried to get to the 40, and he was only able to get to the 37-yard line. That was his goal, to get at least to the 39 or the 40-yard line for the first down. He comes up short. Watch Treffler now come into the picture as Gilbreth comes back toward the inside.
Treffler does a real good job because the Bozeman man defense, Gavin Robinson, really had Gilbreth. He overran him. Gilbert gets the ball, comes back into it. Mike very alertly breaks the ball and makes a real nice open field tackle.
Third down, Ron Slack in at single setback for San Diego State. Third and three. McGuire, long pass. It is complete. What a catch by Claiborne over his shoulder, running out of room and covered by Colson.
Ooh, McGuire's down. Could be tough back there. Didn't see the hit on him. I was watching the ball in the air. We'll probably have a look at it. Danny Directo kneeling over him. But I'll tell you, he threw that last pass, as you love to say, Jimmy, it was an aesthetically pleasing ball. It just drops in there. Here you see him go against Colson and man, step for step. And he just got the beat on Colson and the ball delivered beautifully.
There's no tougher catch in football than one directly over your head. Claiborne never breaks his stride, keeps his concentration, makes sure his feet are in bound. That's a great catch.
And this is of prime concern now to San Diego State coaches and fans and also players. That Dan McGuire, the prime quarterback for San Diego State, is down. So this apparently, and this is from a long way off, a knee injury, and it does not look well right now. We wish that this is not going to be even keeping him out of the game, perhaps for only a couple of plays. Hopefully it's just a twist and he'll be able to bounce back. He is up, and he is under his own power.
That's a good sign. Take the wrap off. He'll be back. Big, tough, strong guy. Younger brother of Mark McGuire, as everybody may know who's listening to this broadcast. If you don't, transfer from the University of Iowa. They have great expectations for him. Redshirted last year, paid his dues. Anxious to lead Al Luganville and this team to San Diego State back to some sense of prominence.
McGuire now 9 for 17, 137 yards. He's been intercepted once. Into the game at quarterback is David Lowry. Lowry gives it to Slack. Slack sliding into the secondary. Slack is finally caught from behind by Briggs. So number four tackling number four that time. Slack almost broke it for the score.
Well, it doesn't appear to be a very good job of tackling by Hawaii. They fill the hole real nicely, but Slack, to his credit, you can't arm tackle. You can't reach out there. You've got to come. Slack, to his credit, just with that great effort, keeps the legs going, picks up 13 yards.
So McGuire now back in the game, replacing Lowry, who was in there only one play. That's good to see. First down for San Diego State at the Rainbow 20. Ray and Claiborne to the near side. Ball is given to Wagner, sliding along the line, being chased. Being surrounded, being dropped, back at the 30. David Maeva would have none of it. And they led the charge of the Rainbow Brigade that time.
Yeah, Matuszewicz and Gabriel, I mean, Matuszewicz is injured. I'll get back to that in a second. My Ava and Tressler do a really nice job. See, again, Hawaii's team speed to the outside. Good defensive pursuit. Jim, I do want to mention, because of our West Coast audience, family and friends of Steve Matuszewicz, he has a stinging sensation in his neck. His return is probable. And Garrett Gabriel, we've been told, is ready to play if the coaches decide to put him back in, so he apparently is okay.
Second down and 18 from the 28-yard line. Wagner out of the backfield, no setback, passing formation. They go to Wagner. He has it. He's out of bounds. That may be a loss back to the 29. Joaquin Barnett.
I was sitting with Rich Ellison and Joaquin Barnett on Thursday watching some tape, and Coach Ellison was pointing some things out to Joaquin and to me, and he said, Joaquin, we don't know if Joaquin can cover Mr. Claiborne on the flat. What do you think, Joaquin? He was pumping him up during the week on it. Right there, Joaquin showed he can do the job. Right, good coverage makes the stop.
Timeout has been called with 1:46 left. When we return, San Diego State will have third down and 19 on the Rainbow 29. Eight started at the University of Iowa, transferred to San Diego State. He is now faced with third and 19. His team trails 17-3. Triple wide receiver to the left. Slack the single setback. Slack sets up on the wing. McGuire to throw. He wants it all. He wants the touchdown for Claiborne. Throws it too long. Throws it out of bounds. That will bring a fourth down. So Trakas trots on to the field.
Briggs getting up real slow down there. Good double coverage that time between Colston and Briggs. They smelled it all the way. They had it there. Walters up. The crowd cheers. Excellent coverage. Offensive line that time gave McGuire the time he needed.
Briggs earlier in this game coming up with his fifth interception. The ball is placed on the 30, we'll call it the 37-yard line. Ray holding. Zy Karen will be the snapper. 47-yard attempt. Kick is on its way, and it is going to the left, and it is no good. So the Rainbows will take over with 1 minute and 34 seconds left.
Andy Trakas comes in as a natural freshman at San Diego State, came onto campus, won himself the job. This may be the biggest crowd he's seen, along with UCLA, this season. He's on artificial turf for the first time. Gotta wonder if a new kid isn't feeling a little bit of pressure out here today.
1:34. Well, yeah, I would say
I
so.
I would say sure. He's feeling pressure. You think that's why he missed the field goal? I think you say he's choked under pressure. Is that what you're saying?
Walter Santiago continues at quarterback for the Rainbows. First down from their own 29. In motion is Dane MacArthur. Jamal Farmer, the single setback. And Santiago is wedged to the turf back at the 25-yard line. Tracy Maurer there to upset him and upend him.
Tracy, Chairman Mao, the first of a gang of four in on the tackle for San Diego State.
That's true. Yeah.
Let me go back to Andy Trakas, though. He is a real strong kicker. The previous field goal we saw, he really split the uprights with a lot of leg. That was a tough shot to make. And the Bows were coming. They nearly blocked it, in fact. It's one thing we didn't point out. So a lot of pressure on the young man. You have to admire a young freshman kicker walking on and earning himself a place in a respectable program like San Diego State.
Conn Smith to the right. Less than a minute to play. Roscoe to the left. Santiago drops back, looking, sets up the screen to Jamal Farmer. Farmer breaks a tackle at the 30, chased down from behind at the 34, Tracy Mao. Made the tackle for San Diego State. And the clock continues to run, 36-35 as you see. That will bring up third down for the Rainbows, third and five from the 34. Jeff Seidner goes out, and Dan Ahuna comes in at the slot. Rainbows trying to hurry. Clock still ticking, 17-16. Now the Rainbows call a timeout.
Not a judicious use of the clock. I mean, in all candor, under the circumstances, Hawaii has two timeouts left. A little bit too much confusion. If they wanted to go hurry up offense there, they just did not use the clock well.
So with 15 seconds left to play in the first half, you look back on how these two teams have played. San Diego State certainly has had their opportunities. The first big one, they went all the way down to the Rainbow 2-yard line. It was first and goal to go at the 2, and they came away with no points. They could not get it into the end zone. They tried to settle for a field goal. That went awry, and the Rainbows were able to come back. And it has been pretty much the rainbows, and Walter Santiago. Walter Santiago coming in for the injured Garrett Gabriel. Gabriel was playing well, had a wrist injury, had to leave, went to the locker room, and Santiago has come on and has done well for the rainbows, leading them down the field on a touchdown drive. And he has the controls here with 15 seconds left to play in the first half. University of Hawaii band, subjectively the best band in the Western Athletic Conference, will entertain at halftime. Third down and five. Santiago looking, chased and sacked at the 30-yard line. 10 seconds left. That could be the last play. Now timeout has been called by San Diego State. Not a bad move at all.
That's an interesting move by San Diego State. You know, down by 14 points with 5 seconds to go, 8 seconds on the clock. They call the timeout because they want the ball back. Ooh, concern for Larry Jones. He's having one great night. We've not seen him all season now through five ball games once go down like this. Here you see him listed at 6'4", 293. He may even be a little bit bigger than that. We'll have to hope Larry's okay because he's been having a great night out there so far.
The great concern going into this season was the youth of the offensive line and the lack of depth for the University of Hawaii. That offensive line really has come on. They have gelled and have been very, very effective. Larry Jones is up, hopping around.
Well, he was one of the guys that really wasn't all that youthful, being the senior, expected to try to be the leader somewhat. I think he's had a lot to do to help influence, along with, you know, Kanani Souza, Coach Souza, and Mike Seawack, the offensive line coaches. But I think Larry Jones had a lot to do with rallying as a teammate, his own players, to really get that middle five going.
And he's got a youngster next to him, Sean Olivato, who got the start tonight, has improved every game. Paul Johnson says he has been the most pleasant surprise on the offensive line.
So as Larry Jones limps off, and concern for Larry, he's being helped off by his offensive line mate there, Leo Goas.
Have to hope he'll be okay. You know, Larry Jones could have gone anywhere. He was recruited by most of the major schools in the West Coast, wanted to get away from Los Angeles, came out here to Hawaii, and he's just had a great career here and having one of his better ball games ever tonight.
Monty Gilbreth is deep for San Diego State. 8 seconds left. High snap from center. Kyle Alou roots it out of there. Oh, what a punt. Coming down, Gilbreth takes it at the 17. Gilbreth is covered up at the 19-yard line. Good coverage by the Rainbows. And that's the end of the first half with the score of the University of Hawaii 17 and San Diego State 3. Staff statistics sponsored by Tony Roma's in Hawaii for delicious ribs and chicken. At your next tailgate party, call Tony Roma's in Kahala, Pearl Ridge, or Waikiki. First downs, the rushing yardage goes to the Rainbows. Passing yardage goes to San Diego State. Both teams have committed one turnover there. You see the penalties, the punts, and the time of possession. San Diego State with the slight edge. So I turn to you first. And I say that in the first half, we have seen a game in which San Diego State again has the potential. They have the weapons, but they have not delivered. The Rainbows have been tested. They have used Larry Conn-Smith, and they've had to go to Walter Santiago, and they've come through.
The Bozo on offense are playing their usual game, and we have the added benefit of having Santiago come in and exploit the San Diego State defense. I think the real key in the game is that Hawaii's defense has been allowed to play like it's been playing in the preceding weeks, and really, quite frankly, they have not been very effective. That is San Diego State at stopping that blitzing on-rushing defense by Hawaii.
One thing also, as far as San Diego State is concerned, we've had some injuries. McGuire had the twinge in the knee. We saw one quarterback for one play, but McGuire still has that potential, and going into the second half, I think that San Diego State's got to air it out.
Yeah, they have to air it out, Jim. The question is, do they go back to the quick game, or can they throw it deep against the kind of pressure Hawaii's given them? I say it again. I've said it throughout the first half. Hawaii appears to have the edge in speed.
Now, I turn to Bobby Curran. And Bobby, when you take a look at this first half, Rainbows lead 17-3. But if you are the Rainbows in the second half, you've got to keep the pressure on defensively, especially on McGuire.
Certainly have to. You can see already that Dan McGuire, given time, could pick your zone defense apart. He puts tremendous cover on your two-cover and three-cover defense in a man-to-man. He can give you a terrible time. You keep pressure on him, he's a different quarterback. They're going to have to get it done on defense.
When we return, we'll have the kickoff for the second half. Hawaii against San Diego State. favor of the Rainbows of Hawaii over the Aztecs of San Diego State. Jim Leahy along with Rick Blangiardi, Bobby Curran from Aloha Stadium in Honolulu. Rainbows 4-1 on the season, and San Diego State 1-2-1. Kicking off for San Diego State will be Tom Worth, number 29, and deep for the Rainbows, Larry Conn-Smith. Here comes Worth, and we are underway in the second half. Rainbows leading 17-3. It will go to Conn-Smith at the five. Conn-Smith only back to the 15-yard line. Good coverage that time by San Diego State. And so we begin the second half. And Walter Santiago continues at quarterback for the Rainbows. It will be first down for Hawaii at their own 16. Santiago six rushes, 32 yards in that first half. Jamal Farmer opens as the single setback. Roscoe and Conn-Smith are the wide receivers. Ball is kept by Santiago. Santiago to the 20, and that's all. Santiago chased down that time.
I always like this particular graphic as we go back and start the second half. You look at the first half, and that is all Hawaii offense, all positive yards. You can see the field goal and two touchdowns. They had the interception on the initial possession, but nonetheless, pretty productive. That last one you really can't count because it was really very little time left on the clock.
Second down and five from the 21. Ball is given to Jamal Farmer. Loose in the secondary. Over the 30, 35, 37. Boy, he showed up in a hurry among the white shirts.
You know what Jamal's starting to show, too, in recent weeks? We saw one move last week, especially, and a couple of times tonight. For a power runner, he really likes to juke step. Boy, he gets out there, he just likes to put it on you right there.
And rarely do you see a guy with his body type. He's built low to the ground. Most of those guys are just pound right over you. He'll just shake on you and try to make people miss, and he's good at it.
That was his 11th carry of the game in the first half. 10 carries, 43 yards. First down for the Rainbows at the 37-yard line. Again, this time it's pitched to Mahuka to the 40. Gain of three, second down and seven. Good fake up inside that time by Santiago to Farmer. And a lot of the Aztecs went with it.
Good point, Jimmy. I was noticing the same thing there. It's Santiago, good ball handling and running that option. He gives you something to think about. Good read.
Derek Williams out of Carlsbad, California, number 38, and Larry Maxey, number 27, there on the stop on Clayton Mahuka. Second down and seven from the 40 for the Rainbow. Conn-Smith and Roscoe are wide to the right. Ball is kept by Santiago in trouble and just gets back to the line of scrimmage. In fact, I believe he lost a yard. Good job that time by San Diego State.
Well, you know, given everything that we were saying about overplaying in the pitch and the dive and let the quarterback go, it appears that the coaching staff from San Diego State at halftime has got that defense readjusted to play the quarterback.
And now the task for the Rainbows is to try to respond to that. They've got to do something a little differently. If they take that away, maybe the quick crossing pattern over the middle will open up.
Interesting graphic right there. You can see why the score is 17-3.
Third down for the Rainbows. Third and long yardage. Third and eight from the 39. Farmer again the single setback. Santiago fakes to Farmer. Pitches back. Carrying the ball for the Rainbows is MacArthur. And they string him out and dump him on the 40-yard line. That will bring up fourth down. So excellent job by the San Diego State defense. Johnny Walker out of San Diego, number 30, leading the white shirts that time.
I agree. Good opening series by San Diego State. They made some nice adjustments at the half. Came out and played the option real well.
Looking at Monty Gilbreth, deep to receive the punt from left-footed, barefooted Kyle Alu. There's the punt, a roller. Gilbreth will let it bounce. Takes it on the hop at the 19-yard line and then steps out of bounds. 11:54 remaining to be played in the third quarter. 17-3, Rainbows over the Aztecs. San Diego State, Dan McGuire, 10 for 19, 138 yards in the first half. He was intercepted once. Here come the Aztecs. They trail 17-3, five-man front for the Rainbows. McGuire gives it on a sweep to Wagner and Herman Talley. Then chases him down over the 20. Rolls him down out around the 23-yard line. Talley, number 75, from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania.
Well, the one thing about that is that at least it's all blue and no red. Every time San Diego State had the ball, they were able to make some positive yardage. You can see, though, a couple punts, missed field goal. They got the one field goal, a couple of missed field goals. So they got themselves in three field goal situations. They made one, missed two.
Claiborne, single coverage on Claiborne to the right. Ray and Gilbreth to the left. Pitch goes to Wagner. Gets a block from Gilbreth. Talley chases him down. And he is short of the first down. Rainbow strung that play out well. So the ball is advanced out to the 29. It will be third down and one. Mike Tressler credited with the stop along with Talley. Tressler actually making first contact.
I think that was an interesting graphic on Darren Wagner as we saw him go to the sideline, because he's been so prolific as an all-purpose player. 10 carries being held to only 27 yards. Bo's doing a good job of shutting down that young man thus far.
Ron Slack in at the single setback now on third and one. Slack. Maeva has him. Breaks the tackle of Maeva. Gets to the 30-yard line and then to the 31. Briggs came up, but not before Slack was able to get the first down.
David Maeva, a little frustrated on the play, had a chance to get Ron Slack for a loss. Would have put them in a punt situation. Slack puts a nice move on Maeva, gets just enough for a first down.
Maeva goes out. Gavin Robertson in the game now, replacing Maeva. Slack out of the backfield in motion, passing formation. McGuire throws over the middle, crossing pattern, Gilbreth. Gilbreth had Robertson beat, but could not hold on.
Happiest guy in the field right now is Gavin Robertson. He just got beat flat out. Unfortunately, Gilbert dropped the football.
10:04 left, and one of the San
Derek
Diego
Sang.
State players is down. Yep, that's Derek Sang out of Burnaby, British Columbia. Went to Rancho Santiago Junior College, the offensive guard.
Big guy, 6'5", 265. Real key player in that middle five for San Diego State. Have to hope he'll be okay. Just, you know, the injuries we've seen down in the field tonight, you can tell the intensity of the hitting.
Gives me an opportunity to say hello to a lot of University of Hawaii fans at the Pony Keg Pub and Tavern in Kent, Washington, looking on tonight. We want to send our alohas to them. They watch us on the satellite every week, especially to George Coronis, who organizes everything up there and wrote us a nice letter about the Pony Keg Pub in Kent, Washington.
He organizes everything, including crime. Nice to see you in Kent, George. Too bad you got deported from Hawaii.
Second down and 10 from the 31-yard line. Draw play. Nowhere. Joaquin Barnett, Manley Williams. Check that, Odom. Mark Odom.
Boy, that's just good, hard-nosed football. You know, teams gain confidence and they gain momentum in different ways in a football game. I go back to the goal line stand earlier in the game, and it was just what the off defense needed to set the tone for this week. And a play like this right now coming at that time, you just see the kind of gang defense and tackling that they're playing. It's all out. It's aggressive. Excellent defense by Hawaii.
Double wide receiver to the right, Ray and Gilbert. Claiborne, single coverage on Claiborne, picked up by McLeod to the left. Third down, 15. McGuire in the pocket. Throws to Wagner out of the backfield. Wagner trying to get around Tressler. He does. Being chased by Colson. Colson rides him down, but he may have the first down. And a penalty flag. Could be a late hit.
I agree. Something out of bounds the way it was thrown, Jim. We'll see. That'll be tough against Hawaii, because I think Wagner picked up the first down. And if they have the benefit of a penalty, it's going to add a lot more onto it. It's a missed tackle right there. They're going to move against. See, he runs through the zone. He gets right by Barnett, Maeva, Tressler, and now Colson in pursuit. It might be face mask, and that's what I think the call will be. You see it.
Face mask on Michael Colson.
We have a 5-yard face mask.
So that moves
the
ball out to the 46-yard line.
See, the defense is not supposed to allow that to happen. You just cannot let a guy run through you like that. He's got to get walled off and tackled. Good job that time by Wagner.
Triple wide receiver to the near side. First down, McGuire has the ability to throw it a long way and throw it accurately. Slack, the single setback. Slack in motion. McGuire, looking. Gilbert has it inside Rainbow territory. Tries to spin away for Maeva. Can't do it. Maeva able to ride him down at the 46. Good gain of the play of 7. Second down and 3.
They've gone to the short game. Makes sense against that heavy rush. We're not surprised. The difference was in the beginning of the game, they weren't able to execute. Now McGuire is able to hit on his passes, and they're doing a good job. The other thing that this brings up is it gives them a lot of opportunity with second and short. Okay, by getting a lot of yardage on first down, now from a statistics or a sequence standpoint, they have a lot of options on second and short.
Second down and 3 from the Rainbow 46. Pitch to Slack. First down and more inside the 40 to the 38.
San Diego State now opening it up a little bit. When you do that, the short passing game quick over the middle, you open something up. Ron Slack taking advantage that time. Maybe a little surprising some people. Little jute step gets a nice game.
At the conclusion of tonight's game, we will be selecting the GTE Hawaiian Tel Most Valuable Rainbow, and the University of Hawaii General Scholarship Fund will benefit.
Good news, Derek Sang, number 67 for San Diego State, will return. He just twisted his left ankle.
First down, the ball at the 38-yard line of the Rainbows. Wagner out of the backfield. Triple wide receiver to the left for San Diego State. McGuire looking left, throws, overthrows Claiborne. McGuire now 12 for 23, 160 yards and one interception. McLeod actually, as the receiver went in that time, he was clear. Pass was overthrown, too high.
Balls were in zone. McLeod played off a little bit. He was closing to the ball really well. If the ball had been thrown there, it probably would have been a reception, but McLeod also had a nice tackle going for himself.
Rainbows lead 17-3, second down and 10 from the Rainbow 38 for San Diego State. Claiborne to the left. Ray, number 17, Gilbert slotted inside of Roy. Wagner, single setback. It's Wagner. Wagner runs into Joaquin Barnett. Loss of 2.
Joaquin Barnett's been playing a great game. I'll tell you, that time there, he was able to make the tackle. So many plays tonight. He's played excellent contain. He's turned the play in. Barnett just with the classic open field tackle. You see him right now from the inside out. You get the good appreciation for his speed. He's able to run down the ball carrier. Sure tackle. You can't even draw it up any better than that. Excellent job, Barnett.
And Joaquin Barnett's been able to do that all game, been effective in his pass coverage, but his run support has been truly outstanding this evening.
Here comes San Diego State, 3rd and 11. Slack out of the backfield. In motion. McGuire lobs it over the middle, complete to the tight end, Ray Rowe, number 89. First time that McGuire has gone to the tight end.
Oh,
and that pays huge dividends.
What a great play on 3rd and 10. Definite passing situation. Bowes were right there. You know, McGuire delivers this thing at the double coverage. The Bowes are coming with blitz. They got man, but they got the tight end. It appears he's going to be picked up. Well, he's actually single coverage by the linebacker, but the touch by McGuire right over the shoulder to the tight end. Excellent job as we see Rowe go back up to the line of scrimmage.
The ball is advanced to the Rainbow 17. Now San Diego State in goal territory. 6:58 left to play. They trail 17-3. Slack, single setback behind McGuire. He gets the call to the 11, to the 10, dragging green shirts behind him. Good power running by Ron Slack.
The San Diego State, known to have a balanced offense, mixing it up very nicely on this drive. A little outside, they go to the tight end, who's essentially a nuisance factor in the San Diego State offense. They don't go to him very much, but mixing it up, keeping the Rainbows a little off balance, and it's working for him in this drive.
Delmar Johnson credited with the stop. Good gain on the play of 7. Second down and 3. The Aztecs threatening. Ray to the right, Claiborne to the left, double tight end. McGuire pitches to Wagner. Wagner at the 5. Wagner scores. Touchdown, San Diego State. And they're right back in this game.
Great run by Darren Wagner. Good block, and they really stretch the Bows on defense. That time right now, they're just going to get it out there. A little toss play to the outside. You can see the blocker leading right there. Maeva gets blocked. Wagner picks up the block. Nice, comes to the outside, breaks. He gets upfield. Good run. He breaks the tackle right there to get in.
Good block by Damon Baldwin that time, the offensive guard on the right side. And Andy Trakas in to try the extra point to make it 17-10. Hawaii with 6:11 left to play here in the third period. High snap from center. Ray scrambling. Throws into the end zone for Slack. It's intercepted. You can run that back. And they tackle him at the 6-yard line.
Good call. That rule was changed about a year ago, you know, and one of these days we're going to see somebody actually do that.
McLeod intercepts. It is 17-9, Rainbow 6-11 left. And Wagner may be hurting.
Good afternoon, Dad. Keep your hands off the fender.
Did you read Chevron Supreme has high octane and tacrolene?
Is that right?
Maybe I could go fill it up.
Just to the gas station.
For even better performance, new Chevron Supreme has 25% more tecraline. No gasoline's better.
3 hours. Gee, Dad, you didn't want me to mix the old gas with the new gas, did you?
Chevron, we're with you all the way.
Just in the nick of time, Bulova watches at JCPenney. JCPenney has a large selection of famous Bulova watches, perfect to keep today's active men and women on time. Handsome Bulova watches for men, stylish designs for women, durable diver watches for deep water adventure, smart styles for the scholar, sporty watches for the athlete. Head into JCPenney and strap on a famous Bulova watch today.
You're looking smarter than ever at JCPenney.
In 1987, Central Pacific Bank shared in the joy all Hawaii felt as the Hokulea returned home from her 2-year voyage of rediscovery. In an effort befitting the year of the Hawaiian, a young navigator using only the sea and sky for guidance helped bring the people of Polynesia together in proud celebration of their common heritage and a dream born in the stars.
Central Pacific Bank, your partner in the business of life.
Darren Wagner is 8th touchdown run of the year. 10-yard run for that score. 80 yards in 13 plays, 5 minutes and 43 seconds in elapsed time. 2-point conversion that started out to be a 1-point conversion.
You know what?
Failed.
And that's the only thing that really hasn't gone well for San Diego State here in the second half. They had the great first series on defense. They gave up one first down, but they came right back, played tough. And then that great drive for the touchdown. So Tom, they've opened up tough in the second half.
Tom Worth kicks, but he kicks out of bounds. And now he'll have to kick from the 30-yard line. Larry Conn-Smith was deep for the Rainbow.
You know, I think that's a good point, though, from the standpoint that they didn't go in there. And despite being down 2 touchdowns and say, hey, we're out of our league, they did anything. But they've come out here in the second half ready to play and take the lead.
Darren Wagner, just a freshman. And he will really, there's the actually the running attack for San Diego State, Ron Slack and Darren Wagner. But Wagner, only a freshman, he has many games and many great moments ahead of him.
Ron Slack, real strong-looking guy. We talked earlier about him. You know, when you get to do these games over the years, you see these players mature and evolve, and you see them year in and year out. Boy, it's kind of a fun thing to watch. Slack has really come along and just matured beautifully. And as we've seen tonight throughout the first half, he's just a tough football player.
So San Diego State will again kick off. Tom Worth from the 30-yard line now. And Conn Smith has moved up to the 5. Down the center of the field, Conn Smith takes it at the 12. Trying to find a hole. It closes as he crosses the 30 out to the 34-yard line.
Good field position. Take advantage of the kick plus the run back by Larry Conn-Smith. 34, 35 yard line. Not a bad way to go. 24 yard return.
6:05 left in the third period. 17-9. Walter Santiago, 8 rushes, 37 yards. He comes out to lead the Rainbows. Ball just short of the 35. Roscoe to the left, Conn-Smith to the right. Jamal Farmer, the single setback. A reverse again to Conn Smith. He has running room. To the 47-yard line. That play has paid off for the Rainbows twice in this game. 13-yard game. That's enough for a first down.
Yeah, such an exciting football play to watch. You know, the old reverse. Here we go. You get a little misdirection. Get everybody going one way. Take out the guys, get the other guys to pull, get the goes out there in front of you, try to throw the block, and leave the rest up to a great runner like Larry Conn-Smith.
And if Larry Conn-Smith could have found a clean lane, it might have been off to the races. He had a little trouble getting around his own blockers.
Eric Duncan came across to make the tackle for San Diego State. First down for the Rainbows at their own 47. Ball is kept by Santiago. Santiago at midfield. Santiago pitches the ball, fumbles, and let's see who has it. Maybe San Diego State. The San Diego State team pointed.
I think they have the football, Jim. We'll wait.
Penalty flag has been thrown. And the officials discussing it.
I think it was an option play. I don't know what the penalty flag is. We'll take a look at it.
Illegal forward pass against the Rainbows.
Interesting. Uh-huh. That's an excellent call by the official. The assumption on that is you know that he's intending to pitch it. The assumption is it's going to be a lateral, but that ball clearly went forward.
Loss it down.
Also loss it down.
Second down.
You know what, though? Under the circumstances, actually a break for Hawaii.
Yeah, they gained a yard and a half.
You know, when you think about it, if I was San Diego State, I'd rather say, hey, wait a minute, that was a fumble. We got the ball, you know? Hawaii retains possession. They lost it down. They were going to lose it down anyway.
Mahuka and MacArthur are now on the wings. Conn Smith to the right and Roscoe to the left. Santiago throws long over the middle for MacArthur out in front, overthrows him at the 20-yard line as he had a step. On Larry Maxey. 5:20 left to play in the third period. That time, another great fake into the line by Santiago. He did have the time. He overthrows MacArthur. It is third down and eight for the Rainbows at their own 49-yard line.
A little extracurriculars after that play, too. Big Sean Robinson pushing a couple of San Diego State players. Temper's starting to get really hot down there.
So a passing situation, you would think. Santiago back, steps up into the pocket, throws long. It is overthrown, intended for Roscoe, way out of bounds. That will bring a fourth down, covered by Clark Moses, and covered well by Moses. And so Kyle Alou will come in to put his bare foot to it. You take a look at Santiago getting blasted after releasing the football.
He's a tough kid, though, strong guy. I'm surprised he went with a couple of deep patterns, though, for Santiago, because he's really good at running, but he hasn't had a lot of experience throwing the ball. And at that short game, might have been a little bit better to get his confidence up.
The ball drifting toward the side and will go out of bounds. And that is not a long punt at all by the Rainbows as they will line it up.
Kyle having an off night. Special teams overall playing fairly well. Alou has had a good year punting thus far. Tonight, though, a little bit off, I think. He knows it. He's a real good puncher.
So San Diego State trailing 17-9, only a 21-yard punt by Kyle Alou. And now McGuire with momentum on his side now.
Absolutely.
And the weapons to make this a very close game. Claiborne and Ray to the right. Single setback is Darren Wagner. Gilbert in the slot to the right. Wagner wedges only to the 32-yard line.
You know, you just said the key word, you know, it gets said a lot in ball games and stuff, and some people think it gets overused, but clearly, I think in the second half, the momentum is on San Diego State side, and so then it's clearly up to this defense to do something about it.
And McGuire developed a little bit of confidence on that last drive. He's getting time. He knows that his short, quick game is going to be working for him. He's feeling like I can take this team down and put it in the end zone.
Sure.
4:36 left to play in the third period. San Diego State second down and eight from their own 32. McGuire takes the play action. In trouble. They sack him back at the 15-yard line. Barnett.
Those are the three guys we expected. I don't know who got there first. It might have been Mark Odom as we take a look at it. But definitely there was a sea of green jerseys around Dan McGuire. There you see it up inside the lane created. I think it's Odom. Odom's going to be there first. Odom gets the sack. Tally right there. Barnett last. Good move, Mark Odom. Great effort by the three of them.
When we talked to Dave Lay, the offensive coordinator for San Diego State, he said the two players he was most worried about were Mark Odom and Herman Tally. His worst fears were confirmed on that play.
Sixth sack of the year by Odom. He leads the team in that department. Third down and 22. from the 19. Slack in motion out of the backfield. McGuire with time now breaks down. He fumbles the ball. And San Diego State has it at the 9.
Well, we talked about changing the momentum. We talked about the responsibility of the defense. We talked about rising to the occasion. On this series, the defense has come back out and established it for Hawaii.
And you mentioned before, Rick, team speed and quickness. The San Diego State players not quick enough to close off some very fast Hawaii linebackers.
Gavin Robertson in on that last play, along with Dana Directo. Santos, Joe Santos, in the kick out of his own end zone. Deep, Briggs, and Seidner. Gets the kick away. It's short. Comes only out to the 35-yard line and bounces out of bounds, and the Rainbow Throw has excellent field position.
And there you see a little bit of frustration by Al Luganville with a 25-yard punt. I was trying to get out a lot of words at one time. As the ball comes up, you can see Al. He just a little tap on the ball like, come on, you're not supposed to be near me. Get upfield. So great series by Hawaii's defense.
We have a penalty flag thrown at approximately the 31-yard line. And the officials talking things over. 2 minutes and 50 seconds left to play here in the third period. 17 for the Rainbows, 9 for the Aztecs. This is one of those games in which two teams who are designated rivals by the conference. Now, designated rivals means that you two guys look like you could be rivals, so you're rivals. But there's more to that. San Diego State and Hawaii, more than the players, more than the fans, this is a rivalry between the coaching staff because they both recruit the same players.
I have a face mask against the kicking team, live ball foul. I have a dead ball, personal foul against the receiving team.
So where are we going?
Okay, you've got two fouls. You've got a personal foul against Hawaii and a face mask against San Diego State.
Well, those are two penalties, too. What could be offsetting penalties? They both may have happened late, in which case the down may not be replayed. It may just be neutralized here. We'll have to see.
I think one might have been a dead ball foul on the personal foul after the play. I'll be interested to see how they rule this.
In cases
like this,
if
that happens that way, they'll mark one off and then do the other one the other way.
In cases like this, it is best to just wait.
Oh, wow, it's a great opportunity to look real stupid, you know? Because what you can do here is try to second guess what the officials are going to do. You sound like you know what you're talking about, then they do just the opposite, and everybody at home goes, that dummy.
Well, it doesn't look like the officials right now are quite sure of what they're going to do. You can see Coach Wagner lobbying on the sideline.
I think what's going to happen is you're going to see one marked off and then marked off again the other way because I think there are different penalties. You may get an inadvertent face mask for 5 and a bigger one for the late hit.
It depends who wins the debate here. They could be in final arguments any time now. I wonder who has the summation.
Well,
Which player?
I think you give it to the home team.
you just said that, right?
Well, it's just one of those benefits. You play at home, you win these. That's I don't think so.
And when you're on the road, you don't get anything anyway.
Well, let me tell you, we got the head guy from the Western Athletic Conference here tonight. Of officials.
Yeah, John Adams is here. That's why they're jumpy down there and they're being graded.
They want to look good in front of anybody. They want to look good in front of this guy.
Here's Gene Wirtz. He's going to explain everything now. He's getting the thoughts in his mind.
Let's see if I was right.
We have a face mask against the kicking team. That's a half the distance to the goal line. Then we have a dead ball, personal foul against the receiving team. That's a 15-yard penalty. The first down.
They're going to give San Diego State a first down. Now, did you expect that?
No, I didn't expect that at all because don't forget, gang, they punted on that play. They punted on that play. It was fourth and about, if I'm not mistaken, 30 or 35 yards. I'm looking at the down markers. It was on 10 to the 41, 31 yards. It was fourth and 31. How they get a first down out of that is beyond me.
Crowd is in this. Apparently, it's an automatic first down.
But
talk about a costly penalty.
Did they rough the kick? Is that automatic? Is that the call?
Dead ball foul.
Dead ball foul. I am a little. Now, Wagner's out on the field, and I don't blame him. See, I thought fourth and 31, I don't see how you get that situation unless you commit a penalty that has an automatic first down attached to it. And I don't think a dead ball penalty has an automatic first down attached to it.
Well, they're deep in the rule book now, that's for sure. You see Bob Wagner, he is adamant with teamwork.
I would not let up if I was Wags, if he's correct on this here. I've never seen something like that.
Well, it seems to me a dead ball penalty, the possession has already changed
exactly. And they weren't in a situation where a penalty would give them a first down. I mean, where do you make up 31 yards on that? I think there's been a mistake made. We'll see. See, Wags, don't give up on this one.
See, that's where I'm confused, because I thought that since it was a dead ball foul after the exchange was made, after the ball went over to the receiving team,
then it would go against the receiving team, but not enough to pick up a first down.
First down, San Diego State at the 20.
Now, I apologize for clearly not understanding this ruling. Maybe it's something obvious to somebody sitting there that can interpret it, but it appears Wagner can't. I can't. I don't understand it. Nonetheless, San Diego State has got a first down.
McGuire says he can't hear.
I can't recall the last time I heard this stadium make any more noise other than the upset win over Iowa. Boy, the fans are into this ball game.
And that's such a crucial turn of events. The fans are incensed. McGuire saying he can't hear. I can't remember the last time I saw a quarterback make that complaint at Aloha Stadium.
That may be a first.
Well, I think the fans are going to let up. This is the strangest thing I've seen in a long time.
Well, the fans are going to voice their... Now, the Rainbow players are saying don't do it, but they're going to do it. They can penalize eventually the other team. Wagner out of bounds at the 32-yard line. That's enough for another first down for San Diego State. Walter Briggs there to knock him out of bounds. So the fans up in arms over that particular call.
Well, I gotta give San Diego State some credit, especially that young man right there, Wagner, because with this place going berserk, they still came out and ran the first down and got the first down on top of that.
First down, San Diego State, triple wide receiver to the right side. Six-man front for the Rainbows. McGuire to throw. Ray. He holds on. Great catch at the Rainbow 45-yard line. Walter Briggs covered on the play. Ray over the middle. Dangerous territory. This is an excellent reception.
Well, Briggs is back there playing free. He sees it now. He's going to time it and just sort of misses it. Ray makes the catch. Good play by Ray. McGuire coming back. Two clutch plays in a row. Picked up some yardage. Bulls have got to settle down on defense.
San Diego State given life, given back momentum following two sacks. They now have the ball in Rainbow territory. Slack is the single setback. McGuire pitches to Slack, able to turn the corner. He has running room, chased down by Barnett. And he is just short of the first down. Good gain on that play by San Diego State. They have advanced the ball now inside the 40 to the 37.
And you got to be impressed with San Diego State. Three plays, three big ones. That time picking up nearly 9 yards on first down.
Good poise on the part of the Aztecs. The Rainbows now are going to be faced with a situation. They got to forget about the call, forget about that. Time to pay attention to business.
Slack Second down and one. Slack may have the first down.
There's a flag thrown, Jim. I wouldn't be surprised to see holding called against San Diego State in there in that kind of play.
Dana Director, the defensive lineman, the middle guard, able to make the tackle, holding against San Diego State.
Now, ordinarily, when that situation had happened, that's the kind of thing, though, despite the circumstances and the fact that the team retained possession, with the crowd getting so into it, you would think that, you know what, it's not so bad. Everybody would be really fired up. But that's what I've been so impressed by San Diego State's ability in the last several plays to do what they've done. Because those guys in green right now should be about as high as you could ask them to be.
Dan McGuire showing remarkable poise on this drive, as he did on the last one, has not let himself get ruffled by the crowd noise, just coming out, sticking with his game plan, and he's been on target.
Second down and 11 from the 47-yard line. McGuire throws. It is dropped by Gilbreth. So Gilbreth drops the ball at the 44. Mike Trussler covering on the play. Now we'll bring up third down.
Well, third and long, too, Jimmy. Third and 11. That's where Hawaii wanted to be in predictable situations. You got to credit Dan McGuire. He put the ball in the money that time. Gilbreth was a very steady receiver. Just dropped it.
That was the case where Monte Gilbreth was running before he caught it. He was looking to change his direction and make a bigger gain. Didn't take care of his first priority.
That's right. Now let's see if the Bows elect to go into man coverage and put the all-out blitz on McGuire.
Third down and 11. The last time in this situation, San Diego State went to the tight end. McGuire chased out of the pocket. Throws. It is complete to Claiborne, but he is short of the first down by about a yard. That will bring up fourth down. And decision time for Al Luganville.
Well, I think it's even going to be a little bit less than the yard, Jim, but you're absolutely right. They're being short. I suspect with this momentum, they're going to go for it.
I think you got to go for it in this position. They've been overcoming obstacles. They're on an important drive. You can't get a half a yard when you need it. I think they're going to go for it for certain.
This could be with 45 seconds to go in the third quarter. The play at Ignite right here as far as establishing control in this ball game.
Here comes San Diego State, fourth down, less than a yard. Slack, single setback. McGuire, make quarterback sneak here. He does. He makes it.
Good second and third effort by Dan McGuire. It appeared that he wouldn't make it, but he kept going. He pushed it over.
And that gives San Diego State another first down as they are moving the ball deeper into Rainbow territory. 26 seconds left to play in the third period. A Rainbow is down as they slowly unpile.
Gavin Robinson, I think.
They are going to measure. They are going to measure. Gavin Robertson down and concern for him now. Should have the first down.
I would think so.
They stretch it out and by half the length of the football.
Not by much. I thought he had made it by a lot more than that.
Claiborne, five receptions now, 110 yards. And we'll be back.
Recent United States Auto Club tests prove it. The Cadillac Seville STS and Eldorado accelerate faster from 0 to 60 on dry pavement than the BMW 525i and Jaguar XJ6. The tests also prove these Cadillacs corner quicker and handle the slalom course in less time. That's performance leadership Cadillac style. And it's raising the standard of luxury automobiles, as well as a few eyebrows.
Enjoy Gold Carriage service with Schumann Carriage, the Cadillac of car dealers.
This week is a wet one. On the other hand, last week was a good one for travel to the Big Island of Hawaii. For the week ending September 30th, Hawaiian Airlines had 175 scheduled flights to Kona. Of those, 85% departed on time. To Hilo, Hawaiian had 120 out of 130 flights depart on time for a total of 92%. I'm Bob Seavey.
Hawaiian Airlines, better on-time performance.
Do-it-yourselfers are always welcome at Napa stores. They buy thousands of different replacement parts every day, from rebuilt engines to a simple gasket.
Tell me you got one of these.
Do-it-yourselfers expect that if the part they want is not at the store will get it from Napa's warehouse most often within an hour.
That's the one. Great.
At Napa, we deliver over 40,000 quality replacement parts every day, day after day.
At Napa, we keep Hawaii on the move.
26 seconds remaining to be played in the third period. San Diego State, all but having to give up the ball moments ago. They get a ruling. They take advantage of the penalty. And they are moving the ball first and 10 from the Rainbow 35. They trail in this game 17-9. Could be the last play of the third quarter. Passing formation. Triple wide receiver to the left. McGuire throws. It is incomplete. McGuire threw as he was falling down. Good penetration by the Rainbows that time.
In the NFL, they'd say he was in the grasp there. Because he was going. He just stood there. Now he's really going down. But as he's going down, he gets the pass off.
And you can tell how strong he is that he's able to get that ball to the sidelines because he's going directly backwards.
And Manley Williams did a good job of getting in there.
Second down and 10 for San Diego State. Gilbert and Claiborne to the left. Ray to the right. Rainbow to the five-man front. Now a six-man front. Pitch goes to Wagner. He's undercut by Mark Odom at the 40-yard line.
Big-time players make big plays in key situations. Mark Odom, that time, we talked about his sacking ability with a great penetration, sure open tackle. Let the pictures do the talking right here. This is good effort. Boy, he was in there in a flash.
And that's the end of the third quarter. So the drama continues. Rainbow leading.
My brother's coming.
Great.
Nice car, but you have a stalling problem. Definitely valve deposits. That's stumbling, a related drivability problem.
Any suggestions?
Turn here.
New Chevron Supreme has 25% more Tecrolene.
Will this work?
Definitely.
No gasoline does more to help your car run its best.
So Larry, what do you know about transmissions?
Chevron, we're with you all the way.
Tim McCullough, Wren Spooner. It's great to be your bank.
Each one of these designs on the wall, to me, is a piece of art.
Tim, as his father, Wren, is dedicated to quality.
You can't control that quality someplace else. Not like you can in your own shop, using your own needles, hands of your own people, right here in Hawaii. Can't beat paradise.
Quality tailored for Hawaii. That's what it takes to be Tim McCullough's bank. Bank of Hawaii. Hawaii's bank.
The Hawaiian Homes Commission Act was supposed to rehabilitate Native Hawaiians by returning them to the land. But through decades of abuse and mismanagement, Hawaiians have waited. Many have died without ever seeing their Aina. How did this happen? How can it be remedied? Back to the Aina takes an in-depth look at the Hawaiian Homelands program on Wednesday night at 8:05. Back to the Aina, a special presentation of Hawaii's very own KHNL Channel 13.
KHNL's presentation of Rainbow Football is sponsored by Lowen Brown, German for the Lion's Brew, a smooth, hearty beer brewed in the spirit of the Lion since 1383. And by Chevron and high-octane Chevron Supreme with Tecrolene. Chevron, we're with you all the way.
So we begin the fourth quarter. Well, you see the third quarter passing San Diego State and Hawaii. San Diego State, 78 yards. Third down, big play here. Third down and 15 from the Rainbow 40. Double wide receiver to the left. McGuire looking right. Looks over the middle. Now throws. It is caught by Claiborne. What a catch. Inside the 20 at the 19. He is amazing.
Well, I like the offensive line of San Diego State that time because in a big play passing situation, they gave him the time. You see Gavin Robinson last getting blocked out, but they kept the pressure away from the middle. And Claiborne came up with a real big-time play. That equals what Odom did on the previous play. Both guys coming through in the clutch that time. Claiborne high in the air, in the middle. What a catch.
Another third-down conversion. We have just begun the fourth quarter. San Diego State has the ball inside the Rainbow 20.
They trail 17-9. Triple wide receiver to the left. The ball is given on a sweep to Slack. Breaks one tackle, but not another. They roll him down short of the line of scrimmage at the 20.
Delmar Johnson doing a nice job getting out of the middle of the line. Lateral pursuit along the line of scrimmage, making the stop on Ron Slack.
Herman Talley and David Maeva also able to chase down and put the pressure on that time. Second down and 11 for San Diego State. McGuire 16 for 30, 240 yards. Last week, 570 yards against Utah. Double wide receiver to the right. This is the kind of formation McGuire likes, the touchdown. McGuire throws. It is caught by Gilbreth. And Gilbreth is ridden down by Tressler inside the 15 at the 14, short of the first down. And that will bring up yet another third down for San Diego State.
You know, what I'm really impressed with is the fact that McGuire knows who to go to. He's been finding his receivers. Not only does he have the nice touch in getting the ball there, but he knows who to go to against the defense.
Here come the Rainbows. Delmar Johnson taken out of that defensive line. Double wide receiver to the left. Third down. Big play again. McGuire, short drop, throws. It is complete to Gilbreth. Does he have the first down? I believe he does. At the 6-yard line. Yes, he has it by 2 yards. Another third down conversion for the Aztecs. When in doubt, go to Gilbreth.
Right there, just a little turnaround inside pattern here. Again, the offensive line really rising to the occasion for San Diego State. They let McGuire get out there. And there you see his height really taking advantage on that replay, almost looking down over the line and drilling the ball into his receiver, Gilbreth.
First and goal to go at the 6 now. Wagner goes in as the single setback. Darren Wagner. Strong formation to the right now for San Diego State. They go right up the middle to Wagner. Wagner, touchdown, San Diego State. And the Aztecs have come right back in this game.
Great run by Wagner up inside. We talked earlier about his having the ability to do that. Here you take a look at it. This is just old-fashioned football here. We need the ball in the end zone, gang. Everybody block the guy in front of him. Give it to Wagner, and he punches it up inside. Great running by Darren Wagner.
Good blocking by Subis, Baldwin, Nichols in that offensive front for San Diego State. So now the Aztecs have come back to cozy up to the Rainbows. It is 17-15. A two-point conversion will tie it. McGuire, no doubt, talking that over.
Why did they have no choice, Jim, but to go for two?
Oh, sure, sure.
Bows have been pretty effective this season thus far against two-point conversions.
San Diego State, triple wide receiver to the left, single wide receiver to the right. That's Claiborne. A lot of room to the inside for Claiborne. In motion is Gilbreth. McGuire throws. Gilbreth, two-point conversion. We're tied at 17. And now San Diego State making it look easy.
Boy, I tell you, McGuire's got his hand up there. He really shipped that ball in there, hit Gilbreth. I mean, that was perfectly executed. And, Jim, all I can say right now is that this guy, he knows who he wants to throw it to, and when he does, he gets it there. Excellent play by San Diego State.
He threaded the needle between Briggs and Tressler, got the ball right in the money, and you're right, Rick, he throws the ball down.
We're tied at 17.
I'm tired of us centers getting no recognition. I played 13 seasons in front of millions of fans, made All-Pro twice, and started in 3 Super Bowls. Yet no one knows who I am. Hey, even if I'm not well-known, at least my beer is. Miller Lite. An All-Pro center doesn't want some watered-down version of a regular beer. I want the less filling beer that tastes great.
Let me get that.
Hey, aren't you Randy Cross?
It's well-known. When it's Miller Lite, less filling tastes great.
Hi, I'm DDIO, and away we go with another great deal from Creative Holidays. Create your holiday to exciting Las Vegas from only $3.99 round trip. You'll enjoy 3 nights, 4 days in downtown Las Vegas with meals, transfers, and a free stopover in Los Angeles or San Francisco. Fly on American Airlines, something special to Las Vegas. Only $3.99 and no additional charge for departures from Maui. Take it from me, DD. Call us now at Creative Holidays and create your holiday today.
There is a place unlike any other.
The Coveted.
From Honolulu to Kahului.
The Coveted.
The widest auto selections anywhere in Hawaii.
The Coveted.
Quality, integrity, excellence.
The Coveted.
The ideal place to shop. 14 automotive lines, over 4,000 cars.
The Coveted.
17 plays, 69 yards, 7 minutes, 19 seconds elapsed time. Wagner, a 6-yard run, and then the 2-point conversion from McGuire to Gilbert.
And that has been extremely rare against this Bowe defense. They've just not allowed 17 play drives, not to mention the fact that they ate up 7 minutes and 19 seconds.
Now, according to John Adams, who is the head official of the WAC and sitting up here in the press box, as Worth kicks off, and it will drift to the sidelines and go out of bounds. We are tied at 17 here in the fourth period. According to John Adams, he said the personal foul, if we remember back now to the third period, personal foul was a dead ball foul. You have to enforce a personal foul. That is an automatic first down.
Yeah,
that is the explanation from the head of the officials in the Western Athletic Conference.
Yeah, and really what you're remembering back to there is the start of that last drive.
Yes.
Because that's what happened. I mean going back to what the origin there within the first four plays, because they were going to punt after third down on fourth, and they end up getting another 13 plays. Point being is that we thought up here that with a dead ball foul that it wouldn't revert back to the previous possession, but the ruling is such that if there is a personal foul, then the team that is committed against it's got to be marked off. I said that well before. Now I haven't had time getting it out. Okay, the team that has been fouled gets the benefit of that call. In that case, the personal foul is against San Diego State. They receive the benefit. The benefit in that case on a fourth down punt situation being automatic first down. Not the yardage marked off. The fact that it carries with it an automatic first down. Does that make more sense now?
Hey, perfect. Perfect sense.
What can I tell you?
Kicking off from the 30 now is Worth. Again, it drifts toward the sidelines, and again, it goes out of bounds. So now Worth will kick off from the 25. Rainbows led 17-3 at halftime, and the Bows did not score in the third period. 14 points have been put up by San Diego State in the second half.
You know, it's one of the added benefits to this, aside from the fact now that San Diego State moves back 10 yards, the receiving team doesn't really have to do too much running when they're getting the ball. But the team that's kicking off has got to sprint downfield. So aside from losing yardage, these guys get a little bit winded. That's like doing wind sprints, and particularly when it's occurring in the fourth quarter. So not the best thing out there happening for San Diego State. I guess the question becomes, can Hawaii really take advantage of this now?
And you have to wonder, is it worth it to get the ball on the sidelines if the risk is to put it out of bounds and move it back 10 yards? I start to think you take a chance and don't worry about kicking away. Just get it in the field to play.
Well, like I said, with you guys sprinting down there, too, they may be more apt to make some kind of an error.
Trakas.
Here it is.
Kick from the 24.
There you go. That's an interesting graphic up there. Bows have been very prolific on offense this year, and they just had that streak broken at the end of 27 quarters. They did not score in the third quarter. Big zero up there for Hawaii and 14 for the guys from San Diego.
Trakas kicks off end over end, relatively short. And the ball is taken by Branch, Derek Branch, out over the 35 to the 36-yard line. And the Rainbows will have excellent field position there. 15-yard kickoff return.
You know, actually, all things being considered, that's not bad by San Diego State. They came out of that okay.
So now the Rainbows, who are enjoying a 17-3 lead going into the second half, has seen that lead evaporate. We are tied at 17. Walter Santiago continues at quarterback. Well, you see the time of possession in the second half. This is Farmer. He goes nowhere. Farmer crosses the 35 and maybe gets back to the line of scrimmage. Brad Burton from Lakeside, California, number 91 there, with the initial contact for San Diego State.
Brad Burton, a twin here, Jim, his brother Mitch, a tight end, but they're doing a good job against Hawaii's triple option.
Second down and 10 for the Rainbows. Triple wide receiver to the right. Ball is kept by Santiago. He's in trouble. Santiago breaks a tackle to the 40. And that will bring up third down and 6 for the Rainbows. I was impressed on that long drive by San Diego State, especially on third down conversion. And getting up or not getting up is Santiago.
Now remember, Garrett Gabriel, who went out of the game with a wrist injury, has been ready for some time to play. We hope that Walter Santiago's okay. Did he get a quick look at Garrett on the side along with Kenny Niumatalolo? At least we were told Gabriel was ready to play. They seem to be, Mike Siwak is talking to Niumatalolo. Interesting.
So concern now for Walter Santiago. He may hopefully just have the wind knocked out of him and he will be able to continue, but another quarterback will have to come into the game on third down and about 5.5.
Well, it's another manifestation of the kind of hitting that's been going on throughout this ballgame. As we said early on, it was apparent San Diego State came here to play tonight. They were down by 2 touchdowns at the half, but they still played with some intensity. And now here, they've owned this second half. Outscoring Hawaii 14-0, but really hitting and playing very well.
Tonight's winner in the KHNL Dairy Queen and Fun Factory Junior Sportscaster Contest is 13-year-old Kyle Watare. An eighth grader from IAEA Intermediate. Kyle wants to know who holds the UH record for most yards rushing in a single season. That's a great question. It was Albert Holmes. You remember him.
Yep.
In 1972, Albert rushed for 1,146 yards in 199 carries.
I remember him very well. In fact, just last week, I alluded to Albert Holmes when we were talking about Lamar Young and the similarities in their running styles. And here we get a trivia question on that. That's pretty good. Albert Holmes is a great running back.
Remember, if you're under 18 and want to become an official junior sportscaster like Kyle, pick up an entry blank at participating Dairy Queen stores and Fun Factory Family Entertainment Centers in Hawaii. So Santiago leaves, and Ken Niumatalolo comes on, the 6'1 senior out of Laie and Radford High School. Third down and 6. Jamal Farmer, single setback. Niumatalolo running. And Niumatalolo may have the first down. He does at midfield to the 49. So Niumatalolo comes in, starts to go left, finds it all blocked off, and then he went back to the right and really opened up for him.
Well, credit Kenny here because he turns near disaster. It looked like it was going to be a sack. White jerseys all around him as he started to roll to his left. Cuts back, goes right, cuts across the grain, and picks up the first down. That's a big play by Niumatalolo at the right time for Hawaii.
So the Rainbows convert on third down. 11:31 left to play in the game. We are tied at 17. The ball at midfield. First and 10. Ball is kept by Niumatalolo. Rolling, has a hole. 45-yard line to the 44. Really took a hit. Wesselman was there. Wesselman has played a real standout game for San Diego State. He does week after week. Derek Williams also helped out on the tackle.
Yeah, I think we've got to mention that Wesselman last week was the player of the week in the WAC, and tonight, you know, he might be up for that again. He's playing very well for them.
Under 11 minutes left. Rainbows have advanced the ball to the San Diego State 44. Conn Smith to the right, Roscoe to the left. Niumatalolo, 2 seconds to snap the ball, just gets it underway. Niumatalolo for Roscoe. He caught it!
When you talk about sacrificing your body for something, how Chris Roscoe came up with that, I don't know. It's his shoulder this time. Last time it was only his wind. So real concern now for Chris. Hoping he's okay, but what a big time play. Nice touch by Niumatalolo. Here you go, man coverage. Chris Roscoe, a little juke step, gets to the outside, gets the step on. He's going to win the foot race. This is just great body control.
Gary Taylor was with him all the way, step for step, falling back, makes the catch. What a catch by Roscoe.
Just tremendous concentration. You get a little different look at it here. Going behind and falling down, keeping his eye on it, and took a pop. It looks like he just hurt his shoulder on the ground. He'll be back.
I think he just kind of trimmed his body where it wasn't supposed to turn. He turned it that much to catch that ball. Great job. He seems to be okay.
Triple wide receiver to the right. Rainbows have the ball inside the 20 at the San Diego State 18-yard line. Ball is given to Jamal Farmer. Farmer wedging, not giving up, still on his feet. And Farmer finally is stacked up, standing up at approximately the 15-yard line. We'll see what they give him forward progress. Eric Duncan had a hold of him.
And it
became a test of will.
Well, late whistle, too, by the officials. Right, test of wills, but that's how fumbles occur, too. And San Diego State knows real well on how to tackle that football. They've got to be careful on that.
Conn Smith, Leonard Lau, flanked to the right. Niumatalolo to Farmer. Touchdown! Excellent choice by Neil Makalolo.
Excellent choice by Neil Makalolo. Credit Kenny. All of a sudden, Santiago gets hurt. The next thing you know, Neil Makalolo's in there, and the whole thing comes together. What a quick hitting play. You see him read the defense. He sees the lane open up. He gives it to Jamal inside. The rest is Farmer because he just flies upfield. Good job. Great execution all the way around.
The 11th touchdown of the year for Jamal Farmer. What a story the UH quarterbacks have written tonight. Set it up. And it is good by Elam. 24 for the Rainbows, 17 for San Diego, and you get the impression that we may just be starting here.
Looks like Daddy's bringing home the barbecue. A big sack of McDonald's McRib sandwiches. Grilled pork and that sassy sauce. Tempting, huh? Like a barbecue in a bun without the bones. And with a big icy Coke, it's, well, you're only human, aren't Daddy? Chomp.
The good time, great taste
of McDonald's McRib for a limited time. Only at McDonald's.
I tried my best. Every job I did, I tried my best. But the thing is that they wouldn't... I had to tell them, I had to tell somebody that I had epilepsy. So in case I decide to have it, they would help me. But every time after high school, I would sign the applications and put down epilepsy. They wouldn't hire me.
Put your money where it will work the hardest.
Ready?
Ready!
At Consumer Tire Auto Centers, we're having a surprise sale.
A surprise for you and our boss.
Wait till he gets back and sees what we're doing. He's going to love it.
We're taking Dunlop's high-performance steel radial with raised white letters and putting it on sale for only $47.
And for only $29.95, take your pick of the SP4 for imports.
Or the popular Questa for domestic cars.
Come check out the surprise savings happening now at your Consumer Tire Auto Center.
You know, they say that the defenders read the quarterback's eyes. This is an example of the quarterback reading the defender and making the right decision to Jamal Farmer.
And when a team does a lot of triple option against you, the first and foremost thing you got to take away is the fullback dive. That time, Jamal Farmer, no problem, up the middle, barely touched.
Well, good response by Hawaii.
64-yard drive for the score, 24-17. Kickoff goes to Slack at the 10-yard line. Here comes Ron. To the 29.
You know what you credit to, you know, you think about running the option. On a couple of plays prior to that, Farmer was just stuffed. I mean, by four or five guys, he went into a stone wall. And yet, with that kind of persistence, they come back and you see him break a play like that.
That's A.C. Green of the Los Angeles Lakers. Lakers training here. And they will play an exhibition game against the Sacramento Kings next week.
I thought maybe he was going to suit up here.
Yeah, he looks like he could play.
Catch a couple. He can't play.
9:37 left to play in the game. Triple wide receiver to the left. McGuire throws. There's Gilbreth. Gilbreth hit right away and thrown down by Tressler. It will give him forward progress to the 33-yard line. The line of scrimmage being the 29. Second down and six. So here comes McGuire. Answering back. Going to work. Reporting for duty. And starting to make things happen for San Diego State. 24-17 Rainbows, 9:14 left to play in the game.
In case you were wondering about Walter Santiago, all he had was his wind knocked out. He is available, he's okay, but boy, did Kenny Niumatalolo come off the bench.
Second down and six. Claiborne, Ray, Gilbreth to the right. Wagner, the single setback. It is Wagner. Wagner out to the 35, short of a first down. It will bring up third down and four for San Diego State. Now, this is a team that on their last drive that consumed over 7 minutes converted third down after third down, converted on those very crucial high drama plays. Now they have to do it again.
And Jim, last drive, it didn't matter if it was third and three, if it was third and 18. They made it happen every way. McGuire's a cool customer.
Third down and four. Galbraith and Claiborne. Looking is McGuire. He throws. It is Gilbreth. First down, Gilbreth at the 42. Another third down conversion for San Diego State. And McGuire and his receivers and his offensive line giving him the time. They continue
to march up the field.
Well, I say it again. That time was real clutch. Bobby was talking about his coolness. Absolutely right. What I'm really impressed with also is his ability to find the right receiver. He knows where his guy's going to be and how he's going to be open against that defense.
They send the receivers to the left side. First down and 10 from the 43. Out of the backfield in motion goes Slack. McGuire throws long over the middle. Gilbreth, he's hit, holds on. Gilbreth really took a hit from Colson, but he holds on at the 31-yard line. Comes up limping, but the ball did not pop loose. And what a hit by Colson.
What a play by Gilbreth, too. This is big time. Colson's going to time it beautifully. He's going to go for the body. You'll see him come into the screen, but Gilbreth really holds on. What a play all the way around.
Here comes San Diego State, 7:41 left. And they have advanced the ball to the 32-yard line of the Rainbows. Rainbows lead 24-17. What a game here in the fourth period. McGuire to Wagner. Wagner chased down, gets away from Joaquin Barnett, weaves his way up the field, able to get back to the line of scrimmage and forward to the 30-yard line. A gain on the play of about a yard and a half. It will be second down, 8.5 to go.
Well, good defensive play at time. It looks like they're going to pick up, yard and a half, Jim. Good pursuit by the defense. I thought they might have marked a little bit more. I tell you, I agree. What a game here in the fourth quarter. Both teams really going at each other. They hit the seven-minute mark.
6:58. Now, remember, if San Diego State scores, Rainbows went for one. San Diego State could go for two. They were successful. McGuire pump faking, sends it long. This is Claiborne. We may have interference.
Claiborne knew it. He put a hell of a move on. He drew the foul against McLeod, on Burton rather. Thought it was 19, it's 39. They're going to pick it up. They're going to pick up a first down on this deal.
McGuire, 22 for 36. 295 yards.
Just can't do that. That's too much. Hanging on. You can see the official right there. Good call against Burton.
You can see Claiborne pointing to Burton with his thumb. Here's Gene Wirth.
Fifteen big ones. You know, though, Jim, that's a little bit like fouling in basketball when a guy's got a definite layup and say, hey, I'd rather have you make the two shots, because with the move Claiborne had on him, if Burton, he gets by Burton, he's in the end zone. So for nothing else on that play, despite giving up the first down 15 yards, he didn't give up the touchdown.
Now San Diego State has the ball at the Rainbow 15-yard line. First and 10. Wide receivers are to the left. Ball is given to Slack. Bumps into his own man. Stumbles. And Dana Directo able to wrap him up. Gets inside the 15 to around the 12. We'll see what they give him forward progress. Only to the 13-yard line. Second down and 8. San Diego State needs the score. 6 minutes, 27 seconds left.
And what has been a great defense through five ball games this year, even in a losing situation, nonetheless for Hawaii, I think, Jim, this is the most tested they've been thus far this season.
Claiborne, Ray, Gilbreth to the left. In motion out of the backfield is Slack. This has been dangerous all night. Looking, McGuire throws, Claiborne batted away. Excellent play that time by the Rainbow defense. Excellent play by Burton.
He made up for it that time. He timed it well. Good play. Stripped the ball. Ball hung up there in the air for a little bit. Almost thought somebody might have picked it off.
James Burton, only a freshman. You like to see a kid come back and respond. Gets burnt, commits a penalty, comes right back the next play and makes a big one.
Absolutely. Big third down play here.
Another third down play for San Diego State. Double wide receiver to the right. Gilbreth and Claiborne. McGuire looking right. Throwing right. Complete the Claiborne touchdown, San Diego State.
Boy, did he thread that. That was big time. If McGuire was looking for a turnaround game in his career, boy, this is it tonight. Right at the right time, he comes right there. He looks for Gilbreth. Bam, he hits him against man on Colson. Gilbreth gets into the end zone. Great execution.
So, Claiborne, that's the seventh touchdown pass of the year by Dan McGuire. Claiborne's third touchdown reception. And San Diego State apparently going for one to tie. 24-23, 5:56 left to play in the game. San Diego State feels they have enough time, and with the way this offense is going, they'll be right back down here. The kick is up, and it is good.
So the Aztecs and the Rainbows hooked up again, and we are tied at 24.
Good afternoon, Dad.
Keep your hands off the fender.
Did you read Chevron Supreme has high octane and tecraline?
Is that right?
Maybe I could go fill it up.
Just to the gas station.
For even better performance, new Chevron Supreme has 25% more tecraline. No gasoline's better.
3 hours.
Gee, Dad, you didn't want me to mix the old gas with the new gas, did you?
Chevron, we're with you all the way.
Here in Hawaii, we've been hearing a lot about the super line of Japanese-made cars called Geo. We've just heard that for the fifth year in a row, the Geo Metro XFI for 1990 has the best EPA fuel economy rating of all the cars in the world. In fact, three of the top four ratings went to Metro. Ah, but do you know where to see and drive the new Geos? At your Hawaii Chevy dealers. That's where.
Listen to the heartbeat of Hawaii.
When the Kamehameha Greek Club flew on American Airlines, they were impressed. They liked getting boarding passes and choosing seats in advance. They learned we fly to over 150 cities. But most of all, they seem to appreciate the quality of our service.
American Airlines, something special in the air.
You're watching Hawaii's very own KHNL, Channel 13, broadcasting from the new Hilton Hawaiian Village.
Matt McGuire has gone over 300 yards in passing, 23 for 38, one touchdown. Claiborne, 7 receptions, 145 yards and a touchdown, 5:56 left. And Trakas kicks off. Comes down, backing up for it, and taking it is Derek French, 30, rather the 20, 25. Out to the 26-yard line. So San Diego State and Hawaii hooked up in a dandy of a game. Tied at 24, 16-yard return. Rainbows will put the ball in play at the 25-yard line. And Kenny Neal-Matalolo remains in at quarterback.
I think you stick with the hot hand. Good decision. Question is, can Kenny keep it going? He looked great on that last drive.
Conn Smith. Flank to the right, slotted inside of Conn Smith is Chris Roscoe. Ball is given to Jamal Farmer, and he is met with resistance right away as Cy knew there to hit him first. Cy really pinched in that time. Gain of only a yard, second down and nine, and all of a sudden this stadium, 42,000 tickets sold, 38,000 showing up. Very silent with 5:25 left to play in the fourth quarter.
Well, this is not the time to be silent, gang. This is the time to get up for it. This is what college football, without using cliche, is all about. Two teams deadlocked fourth quarter, fighting it out, using every ounce of themselves to see who can win the ball game.
Rainbow's second down and nine. Jamal Farmer remains in as the single setback. Neal-Matalolo to throw. Lays it off. It is incomplete, intended for Ahuna. Ball thrown a bit low.
Ball thrown low. The guy who was open was Roscoe. Roscoe got open through the seam downfield, and it wasn't after the fact. Chris just really slipped through the defense.
So that incomplete pass may prove to be costly for the Rainbows in this game, because that brings up third down, long yardage, and now it is the Rainbows who must convert to keep this drive going.
And Kenny Neal-Matalolo facing a situation as crucial as his first play, which was third and five, another huge third down conversion.
Third and long, tough one, a lot of pressure.
Neal-Matalolo to throw. Throws for the sideline, it is incomplete. Interference? No interference, now we get the flag.
That's real late call, but a good call. It took the downfield official coming over. The guy who was closest to it didn't call. He was waving it off. But the midfield official had the best look at it. I think it's interference. We'll take a look at it. Let's call contact, gang. He's in his position. He's everything else. Good call.
Clark Moses called for the interference. Interference on San Diego State. Rainbows will get the first down.
And that's a big penalty. You can see that Al Luganville has become exercised with the officials. He liked the call that the first official made. But this coach is tightly wound.
Well, he should be. It's tough. 1-2-1 in his rookie season here as the head coach. He's a hungry guy. He played a lot of dues over the years to get where he is.
His team has played excellent tonight against the Rainbows. Played the team even late into the fourth quarter. Tied at 24. The penalty moves the ball up to the 42-yard line. First down for the Rainbows at their own 42. Ball is again given to Farmer. Wedging, trying to get to the outside. And Farmer is thrown down back at the 34-yard line. So a big loss on that play. Farmer went nowhere up the middle that time. Johnny Walker challenged him and would not give up on it.
Well, Johnny Walker really made the heads-up play because he did not let up on Jamal. It seemed as Jamal was going to break away from the pack and get to the outside. And Walker just kept coming. And it paid off for him as they throw Hawaii for a big loss. Second and 18.
So Roscoe comes back into the game replacing Leonard Love. And Lamar Young goes in replacing Farmer. Second down and 18 from their own 35. Niumatalolo rolling. Niumatalolo in trouble. Throws. And now Luganville dances all the way down the sidelines, goes out onto the field. That may be him or one of his assistants.
That's Luganville.
No, that's him. That's him.
See, the officials claiming that Lamar Young was in the area. Luganville says, you got to be kidding me. He was going down. We take a look at it. It seemed to me that Kenny threw the ball away also. Because here's Lamar Young, far to your left. He's throwing it way over there. He's going down. I can't believe they didn't make the call.
Well, Luganville definitely has a case.
Oh, yeah, I can't believe they didn't make the call.
I think Kenny's knee was actually touching the turf when we released the ball. That should have been intentional grounding.
Third down, long yardage for the Rainbows. Third and 18. Big play here for Kenny Niumatalolo. Throws for Mahuka. Throws behind him. Incomplete. Mahuka had some distance between him and the offenders and the defenders, I should say. 4:09 left to play in this fourth quarter.
Well, Clayton Mahuka right there was wide open. Somehow he was able to beat double coverage. We had three steps on him. Kenny just overthrew the ball wide. That was the play. That was the call. It just didn't get executed.
Monty Gilbreth deep for San Diego State. Waiting for the snap from center. And Alou gets the kick, angles over to the right side. Fair catch being called by Gilbreth. And he catches it at the 25-yard line. It will be first down for San Diego State. 4:01 left. San Diego State now has a chance to take it home, to win this game. We are tied at 24. And the way that McGuire and his receivers have come alive, the Rainbows will be sorely challenged here. 39-yard punt by Alou. But this is the kind of game that's worth the price of admission. When two teams, rivals, put it all on the line. Well, it's on the line right now.
Great opportunity for the defense to redeem itself with a big turnover here.
First and 10. Wagner finally succumbs as he carries the ball from the line of scrimmage up to the 29. Gain of 4. Dana Directo there making the first contact. David Maeva coming up and helping out. Gain on the play of 4, second and 6.
I think a real good call too on first down situation. A lot of poise, a lot of confidence. San Diego State, everybody thinking they're going to throw the ball, just keeping it cool.
Darren Wagner remains in as a single setback. Claiborne wide to the near side. Then Ray, then Gilbert. Wagner in motion. McGuire steps up, throws it low, intended for Gilbert. That will bring up third down and 6. The time, 3 minutes and 15 seconds left. 24-24. And you know, another third down play.
This has been great opportunities for Dan McGuire. He is exercising, showing a clinic on third down. This is a big challenge for the Rainbows.
Well, I'll tell you what's really key for this for Hawaii right here is if they can stop them, they're going to force them to punt them deep. They should get the ball back at fairly decent field position.
But the way San Diego State has been going on third down, we'll see. McGuire looking, being chased by Talley. Sucked by Talley at the 11-yard line.
think the play of the night right here for Hawaii on defense, because it came when it was really, really needed, and Herb Talley delivered with authority. He delivered that sack. Great play by Herb Talley.
And you'd mentioned field position, Rick. That sack doubly important because it's going to give the Rainbows, the deep safety standing about the Rainbow 40, they're going to have excellent field position.
If they don't commit a personal foul. Briggs and Seidner are deep. Joe Santos waiting for the snap from center. Here come the Rainbows trying to block it. Santos gets it out, an excellent punt. Coming down, calling for it as Briggs takes it on the 45-yard line. First down for the Rainbows. 2:22 left to play in the game. And we are tied at 24.
Well, if you like drama, the Bows have a perfect opportunity, classic script to win this game. They stay with Kenny. It's up to him with 2:22 left in great field position to start this final drive. And this is when Jason Elam is worth his weight in gold.
2:22 left. Roscoe to the near side. Slotted inside of Roscoe, Tom Smith. Single setback again is Farmer. Keeping the ball is Niumatalolo. Pitches back. This is Mahuka. Out of bounds at the 46. Gain of only one.
Yeah, but he stopped the clock. Even though Hawaii has three timeouts left, Clayton with a lot of poise made the most out of that situation. If he wasn't going to pick up the yards, at least he got out of bounds.
2:16 left as you take a look at Boom Mahuka. We have seen the best game of the year by far. We've seen excellent catches, clutch plays, third down conversions, changes of momentum. What college football is all about. Second down, 8.5. Ball is kept by Niumatalolo. He has the first down and more. He's at the 40. He's at the 37 of San Diego State.
Great play by Kenny. He just slips the seam, running the option. He's going to take it to his right, face it to Farmer. Comes up, reads it real quick here. He knows. He tucks. He gets a good block. Cuts back. Big first down. More importantly, excellent field position. He's got the ball just outside the 36.
Excellent blocking again by that offensive line. Larry Jones, Sean Robinson on the right side. Jason Elam pacing the sideline. First down for the Rainbows at the 36-yard line of San Diego State. 1:50 left to play in the game. The ball is given to Farmer. Farmer trying to get outside. Farmer giving ground. 35. Farmer out of bounds at the 32.
Boy, another real poised play by Farmer. He just kept going. He knew he wanted to stop the clock again. Hawaii with three timeouts left. He picked up a few yards and stopped the clock. Great play.
Smart decision. You talk about freshman mistakes. How about freshman maturity? That time, Jamal Farmer keeping his mind on his business.
Maury Paul able to chase it out of bounds. Gain on the play of 4. Second down. 6 yards to go. The clock now. 1:42 left to play. Ball is on the San Diego State 32. We are tied at 24. Pitch back. With the ball is MacArthur. 30, 25, 20, 16.
This play crucial for a couple of reasons. A beautiful run right here. Look at him step through, gets away, breaks an arm tackle, cuts it back. He's all the way down to the 16, and that's important because now you're well within Jason Elam's range.
Sean Robinson with an excellent block. Bob Wagner now has a chance to win it. 1:30 left. The crowd bouncing in the stands here at Aloha Stadium. They sense it. The Rainbows sense it as they come to the line. Tied at 24, and the clock begins to tick down. 1:15, 1:14. Niumatalolo. Niumatalolo to Farmer at the 10.
Farmer wanted the 6, boy. He just kept going. He broke several tackles in there. We may not see Elam the way the Bows are coming off that offensive line. Those are the guys right now that are really delivering. They're punching it up inside.
Gain of 6, second down and 4. The ball is at the 10. Less than a minute to play. You see the clock. Rainbows have maybe time to run one more play. They will run it in the middle. They will give Elam every opportunity. What Farmer is thinking, don't fumble. And there's a possibility of scoring. Farmer should get the ball. He does. He has a chance. He scores.
You could smell it. coming. The offensive line delivered. The rest is Jamal Farmer. He breaks it to the outside. That is just great football, great determination, all effort, all heart. Hawaii takes the lead with 29 seconds. What a great play.
Elam in to tie the extra point. It is good. 29 seconds left. And the Rainbows turn the page in their own storybook. 29 seconds. And Jamal Farmer, who says, no field goal, not this time, not when I have a chance to score. He scores his 12th touchdown of the season, his third touchdown of this game. And you can credit Larry Jones, Sean Robinson, and Sean Alivato on the right side of that offensive line.
Now, Jason Elam might not have been needed for the field goal, delivered the PAT, but this kickoff, real important right now, coming up. Remember, San Diego State has three timeouts remaining, and McGuire has a real hot hand, but take nothing away from the effort that was just made by that offensive unit and that man right there.
Unofficially, Farmer, 19 carries, 87 yards, three touchdowns. Farmer senses it here, and he's able to step into the corner of the end zone for perhaps the most important touchdown of the year for the Rainbow. But there is still 29 seconds left. And with McGuire and Claiborne and Gilbert and Ray and the running of Wagner and Slack, it's going to be an interesting 29 seconds. Elam will kick off. Rainbow's lead, 31-24. What a kick by Elam. Slack in the end zone, touches down his knee, and San Diego State will put the ball in play at the 20.
Well, Elam delivered, and I gotta believe some of that was left over because he was really ready to kick a field goal and called one, so it came in perfect that time for just rocketing it into the end zone. You could just, that's a release of adrenaline by Jason Elam.
29 seconds left. Dan McGuire talking to his coaches on the sideline, and now he is sent into the game. 29 seconds left. 22 of 37, 303 yards. One touchdown, one interception. Here comes San Diego State.
Bo's going with only four defensive backs. They're going to play this straight-up defense.
McGuire, back to throw. Back deep. Throws long over the middle. It is knocked down. Intended for Ray. Joaquin Barnett was there, aiding in the Rainbow defense, 23 seconds left. And now Luganville continues his pacing. He has been a marathoner on the sidelines tonight.
That's why I think he's so thin, boy. This guy moves. He's got to be one of the more active coaches we've seen. Great defense all the way around that time because he had the good pressure on McGuire as well.
Claiborne picked up by McLeod. Ray watched by Colton. Gilbert watched by Tressler. Second down and 10. Clock begins to tick. McGuire back to pass. He throws. It is caught by Ray and knocked out of bounds. He may have stopped the clock. He did. At the 35-yard line, 15 seconds left. Another first down for San Diego State and more yardage for Dan McGuire.
Good job. McGuire knows who he wants to go to now. Talley breaks through, but just a step too late. McGuire again delivering the ball real well. Good tackle by Colson. But nonetheless, first down for San Diego State.
McGuire calls a timeout with 8 seconds left as the clock started to tick. 31-24, Rainbows. We're not done yet.
When the sun rises in Hawaii, lots of good things can happen. Hawaii's Burger King restaurants for breakfast and let something good happen to you.
At Safeway, we do everything from scratch. We're actually working the dough with our hands. Our competitors bring things frozen from an outside source, from a factory or whatever. We use only the best ingredients that we can. We use fresh strawberries in all of our fresh strawberry pies. We have real bakers and not just people bringing things out of boxes. When we say see the difference or taste the difference, we sincerely mean that our product is far superior. It's as good or better than mom's.
For auto parts that are simply the best, it pays to ask the ones who know. The counter pros at CarQuest. That's because your Hawaii CarQuest auto parts stores are independently owned by professionals with years of experience helping island drivers. As part of the CarQuest network, your Hawaii CarQuest auto parts stores can get you exactly the right parts at the right prices. Take the guesswork out of shopping for auto parts. Get the best from the counter pros at CarQuest.
You know, Bacon Universal sells, rents, and services all sorts of heavy equipment like the Upright XL24 aerial work platform we're using tonight for one of our field cameras. Who needs scaffolding when you've got the Upright XL24 from Bacon Universal? 8 seconds left. 31-24 Rainbow.
And San Diego State, unfortunately for themselves, with three timeouts remaining prior to the one that was called, lost 7 seconds after their first down. The clock changed, were moved. Clock started again. It was real costly. They lost actually a whole football play, maybe two on that deal.
Rainbow's in the prevent defense now. And what McGuire will do is throw it up and hope and pray. Rainbow will rush three. McGuire back. And he can throw. He does so. It is incomplete. And is there interference? No interference. 1 second left.
Good job of coverage. Even if he had completed the football there, the Bulls are in position to tackle, which is the design of this defense. They'll play the same thing here. Anything short of the end zone now, here's where it changes in complexion. With 8 seconds, you try to hit the guy in the goal run, he's still got some field, maybe he can make something happen. On this situation right here, with the way they're gonna play, he's gonna have to go a little bit deeper.
Addison is back all the way to the end zone. Well, he's now come out to the 2 yard line. That's how deep the Rainbows are playing. 1 second left, final play of the game. Stranger things have happened. McGuire, he lets it go. And it will be a hotel lobby. It is batted down, the Rainbows won it, 31-24. It was a battle. It was college football in the highest definition. This game will be filled with accolades and frustration and great moments to remember. The Rainbows are 5-1 on the season. And the Aztecs are now 1-3-1. The final 31-24. And for Bob Wagner, it was anything but easy.
The ice caverns, where a beer was kept pure in the cold. A beer so rare, so sweet.